All right, and here we go. Yo, man. Yo, I know y'all. I'm pretty sure that y'all was in that space or not. Was in the space with Marcel and this random dude from Dion out of California, saying he ran for president. He did all this running, saying he ran off a reparations platform. All I wanted to say when I seen dude up there, like, this is what I really wanted to say to him. You feel me? But I didn't get a chance to because the host is a rookie, no disrespect. You feel me? You definitely needed a co-host respectfully. You know, but I really want to get up there and say to Dion, bro, ain't nobody coming to see you, Otis. Bro, ain't nobody coming to see you, bruh. Marcel, hella vetted out here in the streets, in the grassroots, speaking for us, on the move, practicing what he preached. And you really talking down to that, bro? See, that Dion dude, he's way off cold. Like I said, we already know Marcel been vetted. Marcel don't even be bringing up his sexuality or nothing like that. He on cold, but black first. He putting a mission ahead. The mission is reparations. Y'all already know that. And dude, clearly, Dion is so caught up on the sexuality thing that anything that he advocating for or what have you is getting lost in the sauce. You telling us that you in the streets. You telling us that you doing this. But like the brother Sonny said, but you don't got the streets, though. You don't have the streets. I mean, by that, you don't have the people. And you're not the voice of the people. And how you moving, you're not going to never be the voice of the people. All right? This is about putting what's best for us first. And if you caught up on thinking something about somebody's lifestyle and their sexuality more than they are, then that's a problem. He talked more about Marcel's sexuality than Marcel has talked, and he's the one that's quote unquote whatever. That's a problem. We don't know you, bruh. You haven't been vetted by the grassroots. You running your campaign like it's 2008, and we not going forward. We didn't already been through this before with that reparations, a pledge pact out of Arizona. They came up here speaking all this reparations talk, whatever. And he up there talking about K-Slay and all these rappers. These rappers and celebrities, they are not our leaders. Man, no disrespect to brother K. Slade, may he rest in peace, but I'm just saying celebrities in general as a whole, nobody give a fuck about what they think about our repair. They done already sold out. We not going for it. They don't represent us, and this is just where we at with it. Again, I'm advocating for guerrilla politics, and by guerrilla politics, I mean looking in the mirror and being the candidate that you want to see, and also being for the grassroots, by the grassroots, vetted by the grassroots, in support of the grassroots, because the grassroots is the real people that your constituents that you really gonna represent, and that's where we at with it. Go ahead, Sheree.
Oh no, brother Show had his hand up first, and then I'll go.
Go ahead, Show, and then we gonna go to Sheree, Mark, and then Max.
What's up? Peace to the family, man. Y'all know how I be feeling, man. I want this last 40 minutes of my motherfucking life back. Because that was some whole motherfucking bullshit. And the only reason why I was in there is to make sure I had Marcel back. So he know, I had my hand up too, Sheree. So he know, you know what I'm saying? He ain't got to sit around, waste his time defending himself with these, you know, these Democratic shields or whoever. I don't know where this dude came from. And then he young. I'm fucking 50 and I'm on motherfucking Twitter. Motherfucker, you 35, 37, 40 at the most, and you ain't on Twitter, bro? Man, that shit was suspect as hell. Dude was suspect as hell. Like I shared with the family, he really need to go see his therapist. Because I think the nigga been touched. He got too many issues with gay people. Too many issues with gay people. I don't care about whoever somebody fucking around. Ain't none of my business. I ain't never been no type of guy like that. So I don't understand why this is so primary, you know what I'm saying, for him. He don't know Marcel. He didn't take a chance to really study Marcel, get to know him. He wasn't even in. He's going to pop up and think some people going to support him. Bro, you made a real big mistake. Marcel done said it himself. He done made 130 grand with the people. And probably got more than that, because I know I sent them my little twos and fives last week. Bro, you don't really want to do this for real. You out here, you ain't got a job, so you say, I'm just going to run, you know, for Congress. So when I come home to my mama's house, she could be like my baby running for Congress. And she won't try to put me out. Bro, I know the scam, bro. You trying to keep whoever you living with, you know, from putting you out because you ain't got nothing on nothing. Don't be attacking our brother who out here putting his life on the line. I'm from Chicago. I know how dirty politics is. They will tie you up in court just to keep you off the ballot, just if you got some traction. That shit dirty as fuck. You don't know what they trying to pull on this brother out here. We all praying for the brother, meditating for him, sending positive energy, but you don't know what the fuck they planning for this brother if he win or he get close to winning. Because I know my enemy. He a dastardly motherfucker that will do anything to win. And you up here wasting this brother time because he gay? That was a whole waste of my time. And with that, I'm going to pass it over to Sharif. Twizzle, where the fuck you was at, bro? This dude said he was from California. We was looking for you to get up there, man.
All right, we're going to go to Mark, and then we're going to go to Max. Sharia, I don't think she'll probably be back.
Yeah, reparations, separations, and verifications, bro. You already know, man. Great space, man. Tweet out the space if y'all haven't tweeted out the space, man. I know I did. I see that on everybody's timeline. But, yeah, this dude, man, like, he just came out of nowhere. Man, this is crazy. Like, Marcel about to win the race. Marcel, like, 20 yards from the finish line. This motherfucker put out his foot to try to trip him, bro. Like, this is crazy interference. Like, this nigga, I don't know who sent this dude. Like, ain't nobody ever, I don't even know this dude, man. Like, from the grassroots, like, we know Marcel from the grassroots and been vetted thoroughly. Like, we've been saying that over and over and over. And like you said, hey, I ain't with no gay shit and all like that. But, bro, he talking our language. And that's our brother that's talking real nice about us. You know what I'm saying? And he for us, bro. Like, this dude is William O'Neal, bro. Like, this dude came out of nowhere running interference. Like, I'm talking about, this is crazy. I'm, like, trying to think about it. He's trying to throw jail talk and all this shit, bro. I've been in the trenches, too. Like, bro, like, all that shit 10 years ago, you could have threw in the grassroots off with that Obama shit. You know, that whole I'm for the people shit. Man, bro, 10 years ago, that shit worked.
Hey, my bad, Mark. Hey, Twiz. Hey, it's all right. You up here speaking now? I'm about to say, yeah. Someone was up. All right, go ahead, Mark. Go ahead. My bad, brother. Finish cooking.
Yeah. I don't know. I was about to land on my plane anyway, bro. But yeah, that was just talked about. The guy was running crazy interference, man. But I dropped my plane right there. Go ahead.
All right, go ahead. Go ahead, Max, and then we're gonna go to April.
Hey, everyone. Peace. Yeah, so that was a little weird to me, and I think that was an energy suck. I live here in California. Twiz knows that I'm here in Menlo Park, and I know he's in Oakland, but I got to be honest, I haven't gotten, like, an Instagram-sponsored post. I haven't seen anything on television, a flyer. I'm involved in my local politics, and just the basic, he could just reach out to all the local black politicians and get their support. But as he kept talking, and then I went to both of his web pages, and I forget who the gentleman was that was just talking. I think this is like a scam, or like he might just not realize that he's not that guy. Because if you go to his web page, it's just, you know, it's not even it's like one long paragraph. Right, and just how he was attacking Marcel, I'm like, dude, like, why aren't you telling us what your plan is? And there was just all this energy on Marcel. And I don't think he realized that if Marcel was never in that room, we never would have heard who he was. And then on top of that, I was at the reparations meeting. That was in Oakland at the ballroom. So how did he not hear about that? And how did he not go to it? It was free. It's not like, and they gave us lunch, right? And it was a very informative meeting. And I'm just very surprised that he didn't know about it. And if he didn't know about it, then you're not really about reparations. And as well as, guys, it's very delusional to go around saying that every Black American, 40 million, 50 million Black Americans are all going to get a $3 million check. That's just a waste of time, and that's a distraction, and they want you to think that, like, yes, we're going to get a lump sum of $3 million. No, there's something called inflation, which why we need to focus on, hey, if these states have a rainy day fund, we need to start targeting what are those rainy day funds, what is the racial wealth gap in that state, and then taking that rainy day fund and doing what we can to allow us to at least meet that racial wealth gap in that state.
Man, thanks for saying all that. It don't make no sense that he's in California, but he's not talking about that event that happened. I'm across the country and I knew that happened. So that don't even make sense at all. Like, yeah, man, these people out here tripping, man. Yeah, he clearly an agent of chaos, man.
I also think we should take that as a warning sign, because that was just a waste of all of our time, really. Like, we really just allowed him to manifest attacking Marcel, when really, like, we should be cheering Marcel on. We should be putting it in Marcel's head, hey, you're going to win. Not, like, I just kept smacking my hand, being like, dude, what are you doing talking about Marcel? Like, tell me your policy. Tell me what is it you're focused on. Tell me how you're going to make my life better. Talk about rent, right? Talk about how you're going to do something about rental prices and housing prices and the homelessness and the rising food costs. But I think that's when we need to wake up. Whenever someone, whoever it is, starts attacking any Black person, that should just sound on an alarm and send up red flags that, hey, like, we need to stop entertaining this and go somewhere else.
I totally agree. Go ahead, April. And if April not ready, go ahead, Twiz, because I know you out there in Cali, bro.
Buckle up. It's going to be a million people doing that.
Word. Go ahead, Phoenix.
I'm sorry. I'm out here walking my twin niece and nephew, so I might sound a little winded. But yeah, I agree with it. Saying it's going to be a million more, you know what I mean? So, and I, you know, in my heart, I felt like, dang, you know, Marcel getting attacked, and we got to, and by an idiot. I mean, this dude was a straight freaking idiot. That's any differences in our lives or the lives of Southern Carolinians and voting, you know what I mean? So, you know, but we didn't know that he was a complete idiot at first, right? Because he was talking numbers, right? And we was listening. We're gonna get $60,000 a month, you know? And then he came with the crap. And then we like, wait a minute, because I had told my sister and my dad, I was like, oh, we got somebody Black running on reparations in California, y'all, da-da-da-da-da. And then I let them hear the conversation. Then I was totally embarrassed. I was like, wait. We just met him today. I was like, I take it back. Oh, man.
So- See, bro. See? He just killed a man. Man, before he could get off the ground, bro, don't nobody care about what you did in 2015, bro, in 2016, bro, it's 2022, bro. And you talking about you not online, you not on social media with the grassroots, bro. Every goddamn politician in America damn near on Twitter and up here stumping and using this political apparatus, bro. That makes you even more suspect, bro. Don't even get me started. Go ahead, nurse. Cook.
Thank you, guys. I'm glad you let me talk. This guy not going to the reparations hearing, that's a big red flag. And I've never heard of him before today either. I have family in California. My grandmother used to live in Gardenia. And then I have a lot of family out in South Carolina. This was his, you know, this was his chance to make an impression on people. Because just because a lot of people don't live where he is running, we still can tell our family members. But he didn't give me anything to tell my family members about. How do you not know to go to the reparations hearing? I remember when they had the hearings online. Marcel, I seen him in the chat, and he's not even from California. So this guy, to me, you didn't go to the hearing because you don't care. And why is that? Because you're paid opposition. And it was just a big headache. So I was happy you guys opened the space so I could come over here because I didn't want to hear that nonsense anymore. And that's all I'm going to say. I'm going to drop back down to the listener. Thank you, guys.
Thank you for your input. I'm bringing Twiz up. Twiz, bro, I don't know what's up with your connection, bro. I keep bringing you up.
Man,
good,
dude, I don't know what the fuck is going on with Twitter, dude. This shit been fucking with my phone, dude, for the past couple of days, dude. I keep trying
Same with mine, actually.
And it just keeps zapping me out. Like, yellow mic will pop up and it'll drop out. Nigga, I had to turn my phone off and reboot it, like, damn near twice. Yeah, man, I jumped in that space. I don't know who that dude is. You know what I mean? He's not known out here in the streets. You know what I mean? Like you said, he's out there complaining in Vallejo and Berkeley and shit like that. And he's just throwing Oakland names out there. But we don't know that nigga out here. And he talking about he campaigning in front of liquor stores. That's what he's not doing. Because if he was campaigning in front of liquor stores, his ass would be getting robbed every goddamn time. You know what I'm saying? It's hard out here and struggling out here. And the last thing motherfuckers want to hear is somebody coming up talking about political shit. You know what I'm saying? It's funny. I wish I could have got in there because I would have hurt his feelings. Like, nigga, how come we know more about Marcel than you? You know, I'm from the street, nigga. I'm born and raised out here. Nigga, how come I'm chanting Marcel's name more than you? Nigga, you should be embarrassed about that. You know what I mean? Nigga, I all on my timeline, support Marcel for Congress. Free Mason, Tennessee. You don't see nothing about this nigga. You know what I'm saying? That's what you call it. And not only that, if you listen to him talk, he's not prepared, dude. He's getting emotional, he's flashing back, he's snapping off, he's argumentative, and he's hella defensive. You know what I'm saying? You can't win a political atmosphere like that, and you're going against the motherfucking Europe. You're going up against these motherfucking Hispanics? Come on, dude. That's the only thing they thrive on. That's the first thing they thrive on is the black man's angry. He can't do this, he can't do that, and that's all they're going to play on, and he just showed his weakness right there. You know what I'm saying? They wouldn't let that, whoever
and
the host was,
liar.
Whoever that host was, he wouldn't let me up because, you know, he was showing favoritism to that dude. You know what I'm saying? But, you know what I mean? That shit is crazy. And like I said before, and I'll say it again, I don't know who that dude is. He's not a real Oakland motherfucker. You know, if he was like that, we'd be speaking his name like Marcel, but don't nobody know his name. Shit, everybody's still talking about the Mount Westmore concert. Then they talking about that nigga. You know what I'm saying,
bro? It's a shame. It's a shame. It just shows that he's like it's just a testament to how he's not going to win, or that he's stumping wrong, or he's moving wrong, or how off code he is. That you know somebody all the way across the country, literally all the way across the country, bro. And you don't even know somebody in your own backyard. He talking about he in the streets. He at
that
the
nigga not
store.
Know. That's what he.
He
not.
Drinking the Coke 45,
that's what he
bro.
Not. That's
he
what he
sipping
not.
On the old English.
That's
bro.
What he not. That's what he not.
That it not. Stop.
If he doing it, he doing it in the white part of town. He doing it in the regentrified town. That's where he doing it at. You know what I'm saying? That's the only place he doing it at, dude. Because these streets out here don't move like that, dude. You know what I'm saying? That motherfucker's on some new and approved type shit. And like I said, I had my hand up for the longest. The host wouldn't let me in. Then I got a phone call and dropped out. Then that nigga, Black Voltron, not Black Voltron, what's that other nigga ain't Black Wall Street. He called me, man, you not in there? I'm like, well, shit, I got things to do. But then when I get back in there, Black Voltron ripping him a new asshole. So, you know, hey, he can only get flashed on so many times. They wouldn't let me come up. And the dude keep talking about, I'm about to end the space. I just go over there. Now that cocksucker co-hosted. And nigga Dion co-hosting, like, are you serious? So we know who your dog in the fight is. You know what I mean? A lot of these niggas do. These niggas chasing political clout. And that nigga trying to go the route of Kamala Harris, the only thing he can't get on his knees and do it. You know what I mean? But he exposed himself talking about, well, when Marcel get in there, what is he going to be? We like, you kept saying, we like, who was you speaking for and who was you talking about? You know, he kept exposing himself. That's why they say loose lips sink ships. You let a motherfucker talk long enough, they going to expose their whole plan. You know what I'm saying?
Who was that host?
And we already seen that. He said he's new to this, and this is like, that's the first space that he running. And if that's true, man, kudos to him, because that's a great first space to be going. But yeah, he definitely needed help running that space. I'm about to do this brief intermission, and then we're going to keep on going.
Payback! That's it! Payback!
Yeah, pay us some goddamn reparations. Yeah, y'all. Yeah, we gonna keep moving and getting into this. Everything that y'all couldn't, everything that we couldn't say in that space because of the host is new. Respectfully, we gonna say it in here. You know, I wanted to just tell dude, like I said, I wanted to get up there and say, Dion, ain't nobody coming to see you, Otis, bruh. All right, that's what I wanted to get up there and say. And I also just wanted to say that this is the new thing that I wanted to say. After leaving that space, the impression that I got, or the lasting thought, is about Marcel's sexuality. I don't remember no politics, no nothing. You spend more airtime talking about, again, like I said, his sexuality than he's pretty much ever had since he'd have been in all our goddamn spaces. Bro, you just said it more than him. I don't even hear him talking about it. He don't even bring him up. That's how you know he beat one. Also, he was on. also, he was on Jason Black, and Jason Black vetted him. Jason Black was throwing them questions at him, you know, to see what he was going to say, or if he was going, you know, be on that first. But no, he's improved every time, bro. That guy is an agent. Either one, he's an agent. Two, he don't know the political arena how it is right now, and that we out here stumping this hard and using social media as a political apparatus and doing this in person. All right, and then number three, he think that we just going to talk down about Marcel because of whatever he chooses to do, bro. That ain't working, bro. You in a new political climate trying to run on old political ways, and we not going for it no more. Check Pete. We running the narrative now. All your political candidates or whatnot, they're on social media. So if you're not on social media, you're not using this as a political apparatus, then you not only off code for the grassroots, you off code to be a politician. Because if I run, God damn it, I'm definitely going to be using social media. Because you can meet somebody all the way across the country, get support all the way across the country, get people to support your campaign all the way across the country. Like my brother, like Twizzle, he's all the way in California. Goddamn, Marcel all the way in South Carolina, but he's still getting support. This is the point we're trying to make. So either you all three of those or one of those. No matter which one you choose, Dion, you are off code. All right, we're going to go to my brother Montana. We're going to go back to Phoenix after that. And then we're going to go to my sister. Yikes.
What's going on, family? Shout out to you, Harriet, bro, because I was so thinking, I was like, bro, we got to have a space, you know what I'm saying? Because it was so much that, bro, you know that we all wanted to say, and he dropped me off the stage before I was finished even with my point, but, you know, like I said, respect to the host. He made him mad, Tanner.
Hey, you made him mad. Yeah, man. You was like, yeah, I'm clean, Tanner, South Atlanta, country grammar. You made him mad when you said that.
Yeah, man. You introduce yourself to us, hey, family.
I love my nephew for that, man. I love my nephew.
I love you too, my dog. You know what's going on, man. You got to introduce yourself to us. Like I said, I go click on your
Hey, hold up. Hold up, before you get into it, bro, you gotta do it, bro.
Yeah, man. I'm going and I look on your profile. How you gonna say you're a reparations candidate? You know what I'm saying? And you speaking on reparations in California, and you not tapped in to what's going on in California. That's the first question that I have. Before you explain anything else to me, you have to explain to me how you want me to believe that you are a reparations candidate, and everything that you're talking about reparations was after AB 3121. And you didn't even talk about that. So are you somebody who's just listening in the background and hear what's going on in the grassroots and trying to come and infiltrate and use the talking points to get the support of the grassroots? Because it don't seem like you didn't actually put in some real work, because if you were actually tapped into any type of political structure that was going on in anything in California, you would have been up there and you would have seen Max, because Max was up there. Yaya was up there. You know what I'm saying? We know a bunch of people that was up there. You know what I'm saying? That was up there getting it in, because we were tapped into it, because Cherie DC, the person that you sitting up there trying to argue with, hosted a live space and put us on to the California Reparations Task Force, as well as the one in Minnesota, and sat there and held spaces for like 10, 12 hours long, where we was all sitting there tapped in and tuned in to what was going on, and we didn't hear anything about you. Where were you? What were you doing? You know what I'm saying? What did you have going on? But now you want to come on the stage and try to discredit anything. Marcel, the person that would that has been stepping on, the person that has been speaking, you know what I'm saying? The person that's out there, that's boots on the ground at Jim Clyburn's Fish Fry, you know what I'm saying? Talking about, this man was at his ops Fish Fry talking about reparations. Where are you at? You're not even at AB 3121. What you got going on? So, bro, I don't know who you is, but you off code. You's an op. And I think that you were sent, you know what I'm saying, to try to throw some type of division a week before. You just pop up a week before election time talking crazy. Come on, bro. Nah, it's too late. You know what I'm saying? And you really, like my boy Black Voltron says, you failed your interview, my dog. You failed. You know what I'm saying? It's over with for you. And you would not get none of my support. Ever, you know what I'm saying? If anything, I'm telling everybody to cause see all this, and I'm just gonna say this because y'all know I'm long-winded and I'm a land, but all this, man, bro, we do not care about your religion, your sexuality, we do not care about your gang affiliation, you know what I'm saying? We do not care about your I don't care about none of that shit, bro. If you are B1 Black First, if you have a Black agenda, if you are for reparations and cash payments for my people, then you have my support, and we can put everything else to the aside. Even if you know what I'm saying, as long as you're not messing with them damn kids, you know what I'm saying? And as long as you ain't stealing and killing my people, you know what I'm saying? Everything else I can look past, and I can even respectfully choose to do reparations with you from a distance. You can even do it over there, you know what I'm saying? And I can do my thing over here, and it can be respectful, you know what I'm saying? But coming at somebody for their sexuality, when somebody who has been open about that, you know what I'm saying, who has been, you know what I'm saying, at the forefront, speaking about, you know what I'm saying, everything that we really need to talk about and open about their sexuality, bro, that shit's hateful, you know what I'm saying? And I went on your page and I seen the nigga page, and you got more shit negative to say about gay people than you got to speak about reparations or any type of thing. So yeah, man, bro, off code, you a lame, and you don't get no support.
Marcel, I don't see how you hating, how you can hate from outside the club. You can't even get in. You know what I'm saying? How you hating from outside the election and you can't even get in? How you hate outside of the grassroots and you can't even get in? Get your ass out of here, bro. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Let's go to Phoenix and let's go to my sister Likes and keep this rolling, bro. We not playing with motherfuckers, bro. Y'all thought we was playing. This is guerrilla politics. We about to take over all across this country, all right? We gonna get our brothers and sisters who got master degrees in political science, all that hoopla. We gonna get out here and do guerrilla politics. We gonna go on YouTube, learn this. We gonna educate ourselves, educate our people, and we gonna control our destiny and politics going into the future. That's how we doing it right now. See, we making this fun and entertaining, but at the same time, we're advocating for our people. And this is the move right now. And this is gonna get going forward, and this is going to get us what we want. And there's no signs of slowing down, and we're not slowing down. Sister Phoenix, it's on you.
Yeah, thank you. I was laughing because I thought that when Cadillac said, man, you know, when you keep, you said you ran in 2015.
Hold on, one moment. I apologize. Everybody in here, please tweet out the space if you haven't already. Just a super brief overview. We just doing a recap of the Markell and Deion space. I'm pretty sure you all have heard about it. Yes.
You can that's it.
Go ahead, Phoenix.
Hey, family.
Go ahead, Phoenix.
Hi, April. So Cadillac said, man, because I was thinking the same thing. I was like, dang, he been running since 2015. We still don't know about him, right? And you running for president. Anyway, my whole thing was with Cadillac said, man, you keep doing the same thing. That's the definition of insanity. And I was thinking the same thing. That's all. I'm done.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, he is insane. He is insane to think that he gonna step into the grassroots and then he gonna get any respect, any advocacy, any respect or votes from his constituents. Like, no, it's not going down like that. April, if you want to say something, go ahead. If not, I'm gonna go ahead to go to yikes.
It's insane for him to think that we would believe that he was a reparations candidate in the fucking state of California, and he didn't show up at the public hearing. He didn't show up in Oakland. I mean, that just happened. I was there. Nigga, I'm in Georgia, and I was there. What is we talking about? I'm so confused. How are you on a reparations platform, and you are not actively involved with California reparations? Like, we should have known you because you was at the fucking task force, because you called in and gave a comment. I gave public comment. What the fuck are we talking about? So I'm confused as to how you, well, what he thought, where he thought he would come in and say that he was running on reparations. And like Voltron said, a week before elections, and he thought, like, you know, people really, you know, that was, you know, he was like, I've been clear. No, it's clear that you are not running on a reparations platform because you are not active in reparations in California. That was just crazy for me. And yeah, so sorry. Hey, go ahead, yikes. I'm sorry. I've been waiting to let that out. God damn.
I know, and you're right, because I mean, that's ridiculous. First of, and I'm trying to wrap my head around this, because that whole space really got my head throbbing. You know what I'm saying? Hey, Harriet Tubman's pissed. I really appreciate you for holding this space after this, because my head is just hurting. First of all, I am Alphabet. Y'all know I'm Black First B1. Let me be real about it. I ain't even FBA, but I'm an Alphabet person. But I didn't even know Marcel had that going on. This is news to me, because I've been sitting here and I'm sitting here watching Marcel and Tariq double team these two tethers on the business of being Black. And then I'm watching Tariq and Marcel go out, and, you know, I'm watching YouTube videos. I'm watching Marcel speak his piece and show how he's going to get reparations and give his plan. And he's out here trying to inform people and get the message out there. And I see him on social media, and everything that he does, he sits with us. He talks to us. He gives us information. And I've never even heard him speak about that before, ever, until tonight, when this random dude has come on and onto the space with Black Think Tank, who doesn't know how to run his space. And now he's talking about stuff that's going on in Marcel's personal life. I had no clue about this shit. You know what I'm saying? The whole conversation got completely derailed because the nigga's off code. Okay? Part of the code is saying, first of all, we all know what the code is. B1, Black First. It doesn't matter what affiliation you have. If we was all discriminating and saying only Christians could be in the B1, then it would be a different story. And you wouldn't be sitting here trying to defend what you had to say, because it's ignorant to say in the first place. Who cares what Marcel is doing in his day to day? We are trying to collectively, as a group, as a diaspora of Black people, get reparations for what was done to us in the past. We're not sitting here talking about what's going on in Marcel's home life. What the hell does that have to do with reparations? That doesn't even make sense. And then this idiot, you know, he gets on here and says, oh, well, I'm in the streets. I'm at the liquor store. I'm on the ground. We doing work out here. I'm so sorry, sir, but that doesn't make any fucking sense. Everybody knows that in this new day and age, if you have a cell phone, that's the quickest way to get connected with people who have like-minded thoughts as you. That means that your platform, your base is going to be online. You're not going to see everybody out here wearing a shirt saying, I'm Black First, I'm B1, I'm FBA. It ain't on no damn shirt. Nigga, you got people on here all night advocating for the FBAs and the American descendants of slaves and the freedmen out here. And you get up here trying to cosplay as a damn politician. Absolutely abhorrent. Fucking getting on here talking about what Marcel is doing. When I see him every day, I've never even heard of you. I've never seen you out here doing nothing for Black people. I never seen you get up and debate anybody, because the reality of it is that you are fucking delusional in your mind if you think that you have something to say towards somebody who I've seen. And you can look them up on the internet. You can look them up on YouTube, Twitter, you Instagram. What the fuck? What? Which app do you need to see him? Out here doing the right thing and being Black First, the exact thing that you aren't. So maybe he was just jealous and wanted to get a word in with Marcel, because he got real sensitive when somebody's talking about stuff being in his mouth. But let me tell you something, as an outbound person, none of that shit hurt my feelings.
That shit was funny as fuck, sis. Sorry.
I know that's damn right. Marcel's feelings wasn't hurt either. You know why? Because we already get it from every other which way, and that wasn't even part of the conversation beforehand. So you want to bring it to the table? Marcel brought it to your ass. How the hell? How dare you? And I'm laying there. What the fuck?
Thank you for cooking, sis.
You know what, sis? And I'm glad you said it, right? Because Marcel, and we've been vetting him for a long time now. I myself, not as long as many others, right? But he has never led with that, right? And so for you to not even like, whoa, for real? He is, right? Because he doesn't lead with that. That's not, that he's not in that fight at all. His fight is for Black Americans, for freedmen, for foundational Black Americans, for American descendants, a chattel slavery and Jim Crow laws. That is who his fight is for his lineage, who he is, because your lineage always, right? Not even Black First, your lineage always, right? Ain't nothing ever gonna change that. You can't change your lineage, nigga. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I appreciate you saying that, right? Because he has never, ever, 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 ever led with that. Ever. You would never know. You only know because you know what I'm saying?
I had no clue until today. Absolutely not a clue until this random dude bring it up. What the fuck does that have to do with reparations? I was so, my head was just throbbing.
Okay.
All right, sister. Hey, we gonna sorry, I gotta switch up the I gotta switch up the order, because the big steppers, the high steppers, then came into the room. You know, Cherie and Divine. You know, they take presidents, and then after that we gonna go to Freedom.
You go to Freedman.
Yeah. Then we go to Freedman. That's what I meant to say. Then we gonna go to Max. Then we gonna go to Latagia, and then Death, in that order.
Y'all, I'm so sorry that I dropped out of here like I did before, but I saw the message and saying Marcel said bring me up. I had to slide back in because I needed that to hear my voice. I need you to understand that this is not 1969, nigga. You're not just gonna say Black First, fucking reparations, and niggas finna flock. And the fact that he kept reiterating his little weak ass resume, just because, like, let me be clear, okay? I could say I ran for president in 2020, nigga, because I wrote myself in. That's not an accomplishment. Nobody knows you, nigga. Nobody. So you're not finna step into no fucking Black space, not today in 20 motherfucking 22, and think that shit gonna rock, and that's enough. Like, this egotistical, self-driven, like narcissistic outlook on everybody got to support me because I know what's right and I know what's best. That's Boule 2.0. Come on, man. How is that different from the fucking Coon Congressional Black Caucus? How is that different? And I'm so glad that we have these type of situations, because listen to these motherfuckers. They tell you exactly who they are, okay? They're not even hiding that shit. That's why I had to shout out Brandon Dean. At least this nigga, like, he's young. He's very young. Okay? He don't know. Maybe he could be guided and molded, and we can really make him into what we, the type of, you know, politician that we need. But at least he had enough respect for our intelligence that he tried to give us that little political babble. You know what I'm saying? And try to slide some shit in here and there. This nigga over here was like, you don't got to vote for me. Fuck you. Of course we know that we don't have to vote for you. What are we talking about?
So please, y'all, pay attention. We have to be involved in these conversations because they're going to tell us who we are, and it's up to us to hold them to that. So, and shout out to Marcel. That's the homie, okay? And please don't ever get so comfortable with any fucking representative that you do not continue to hold them to the code. You better keep putting our collective first. You better not try to fucking pivot all of a sudden and start saying black and brown or black and anything else. Nah, we ain't doing that. So I just love that this was a lesson. I'm so glad that so many of us showed up, and I'm glad that Marcel continues to prove that he is putting us first. So thank you.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Go ahead, Brother Devon.
Yo, what's good, Harry's Pistol? Real shit. Like, you talking about heavy hitters. 5'3" Sharia is the real heavy hitter. Like, she the one that got the VIP access and shit. I had my hand up for like 3 hours. I couldn't even get up there. Marcel gave it a backstage pass, so it's all good. We see who the favorites are, but ain't no beef. But real shit though. Like, I have heard of this dude before tonight's space, but it wasn't on no major shit. What's crazy is it was on a Twitter space that Tariq was doing one night. You know how he do them late night. I'm on the East Coast, so that should be like in the middle of the night. I couldn't sleep, and he was bigging up Marcel after one of the debates he did. I think it was after the Michael Harriet debate where he cooked his stupid ass. And all of a sudden, this dude came on out of nowhere. He came on as one of the speakers, and he started talking his whole DGLM, whatever that shit is. And Tariq was like, what the hell is that? And he was like, oh, yeah, then he started giving that same bullshit resume that he gave today. And I'm bringing that up because, you know, what we got to understand is that there's going to be a whole bunch of grifters, a whole bunch of people that ain't really bout shit in this space. And like Sheree just said, to say that you ran for president, motherfucker, Jesse Jackson ran for president. What the fuck that mean to us? That don't mean shit. You know what I'm saying? And so for him to have to try to use that as a way to get in good, that's that street hustler in him. You know what I'm saying? He tried to hustle, but what he didn't know about the Black American grassroots is that we hustlers too. You know what I'm saying? That we come from all walks of life. So you can't pull that stupid shit over here. You're going to have to come much better than that. And even if he wasn't as stupid as he was to try to put sexuality over B1, over lineage first, right? Everything he displayed tonight is more than enough evidence on why none of us should ever fuck with him. No constituent in California, nowhere. And the reason why I'm saying that is because of this. If you're that stupid and you're that ignorant to make that much of a political miscalculation that you come for the people's champ. I don't give a shit if you saw a sex tape with Marcel in it. He the people's champ. You better find out why the people are still rocking with him and that sex tape is out. You better come to the grassroots humbly and say, listen, I saw this. I heard this. What's going on? What's up with Marcel? For the simple fact that you didn't tap into the streets, you claim you're a street dude. But you didn't hit the grassroots to say, look, what's going on? Or here I am and nobody know you. You didn't make no rounds on the Black American grassroots, the new black media. You didn't do none of that shit. And then you had the nerve to call out the people's champ that we've been vetting since day one. You all fucked up in the game. I don't give a shit how many bumper stickers you pass out. I don't care how many liquor stores you go to. I don't care if you say rounds on me. I don't give a shit what you do. For him to be in California talking about reparations, his DGLM bullshit, and you wasn't a part of none of the listening sessions, you didn't testify, you didn't go to any of the, you didn't even go to the meeting that just happened, and the grassroots threw that too. I won't go as far as saying he an op. I don't know. He could just be dumb, but he's either an op or he's very, very, very fucking stupid. Either way, we don't got the time or the bandwidth to waste our votes and energy on somebody that stupid. And Sheree said it best. If you can't see the bigger picture, and I'm going to pull my iron horse to the station right now. If you can't see the bigger picture to put aside whatever personal shit you got with homosexuality to say this is what's going to be the best interest of the collective, and Marcel's track record is fucking pristine and on the record and documented, like, man, listen. I don't know who this dude is, where he came from, but I don't give a shit how much hip hop or how many presidents he ran for. And then you invoke Lord Jamar, like we not finding out in real time that Lord Jamar is a fucking coon. Listen, he all the way fucked up, and he got us fucked up thinking we're gonna let him come up in and try to fuck Marcel up. Marcel got this. We got Marcel back, and I hope he found that out tonight.
Thank you for your input, family. You all are going to do this brief intermission. I wanted to tell you all thank you for joining us to do this Marcel and Dion recap about this political advocacy that Marcel is pretty, is, you know, have already proven itself. And then we got Agents of Chaos coming into this reparationist space and thinking that we're not on code and that we don't know what we're talking about. Sadly mistaken. Please tweet out the space. Please follow me, Marcel, please follow April Montana. Hey, I got to give it up to Black Voltron for going up in there cooking. Follow that brother. Follow Devon.
I did not hear my name.
Follow Kari. I was getting to you. You the main event.
What the fuck, nigga?
How dumb. I was getting to you. Well, clearly she needs no introduction. You know, Cherie DC, she's not 5'3". All right, y'all better not say that. She is
I'm 5'6", niggas.
Okay. Hey, look, niggas, okay. I told y'all. Y'all better follow her.
She got the platform boots. All right.
Let me get into this intermission. All right. Respectfully, this is an FBA public service announcement. I say again, this is an FBA public service announcement. In these FBA spaces, you may hear us use Black and Negro interchangeably between race and ethnicity. The reason why we do this is because we made our ethnicity transcend our race 2 times plus in counting. Like with the Negro League, I'm Black and I'm proud. Say it loud.
Some people say we got a lot of malice. Some say we got a lot of love. I say we want to be bigger. If we get what we deserve, we will be beautiful. And we've been scarred. We've been really bad talking about as sure as you want. Just as sure as it takes 2 eyes to make a pair. Brother, we can't quit until we get our share. Say it now.
Black is beautiful. The Black Panther Party, all while raising the American Black consciousness of our people across the nation for generations and more. And we represent the identity of Blackness around the world, no matter if you like it or not. When people think of Black people, they think of us, foundational Black Americans. We are transcending race yet again into ethnicity with being foundational Black Americans. We are the definitive culture. Again, this has been an FBA public service announcement. Please stand by. All right, now we're going to go to our brother. We're going to go to Freeman. All right.
And then what's going on?
Hold on one moment. I need to get this order. And then y'all, let's keep them hands up. We're going to go to Freeman. All right. Then we're going to go to Latagia. Then we're going to go to Max. All right. Then we're going to go to Death. Then we're going to go to Padrino and then DJ. All right, that's going to be the order. Go ahead, y'all. Cook.
What's going on? First of all, that.
Hold on, before you go real quick, Freeman. Ooh, I ain't got nobody in a minute. I just wanted to say this real quick before we move forward. Hey, man, you always got to come respectfully and humbly to the grassroots. And if anybody don't know, you know what I'm saying, Marcel ain't never went to Tariq. He didn't go to Jason Black. He didn't do none of that. He came to the grassroots and said, look, bro, you know what I'm saying? I need y'all support if I want to get up there. And when Tariq and the new Black, and when everybody started, they didn't come to Marcel just supporting him. They vetted the shit out of Marcel first and said, oh, okay. Yeah, this brother, he on code. He is what it is. And ever since then, you know what I'm saying, bro, just listening to Tariq. If y'all ain't been in the room with Tariq and Marcel be tag teaming them folks, man, that shit's so beautiful. You know what I'm saying? But I just wanted to say that real quick, U.S. Freeman. But yeah, man, come to the grassroots respectfully and humbly, always.
Montana, Mr. Muta nigga.
All right. You too. Hey, Freeman, after you, actually, I'm going to go to Black Voltron because, like, yo, he the MVP in the room right now for what he did, so I have to switch up the order. Hey, y'all know the hot steppers take presidency over everybody else. No disrespect. Go ahead, Free.
Yeah, first of all, I appreciate that commercial break. That was everything. Harriet Tubman's pistol, I don't know if you remember me, but I am the Twitter handle formerly known as Call Me Perrette. I have been perma-banned by that name off of this app.
Wait, that's Call Me?
Yeah,
this is Call Me.
What's going on? So I was confused when I heard this dude's name and said, one, he ran for president in 2020 under a reparations platform, because most people don't know this, but I am a California voter. I live in San Pedro. I was a member of ADOS SoCal back when we were ADOS SoCal.
The right? organizer.
And, yeah.
That's me. Yes, sir.
And I was also the campaign manager for Tara Perry, who ran for District 8 City Council in 2020. Right. And so I was very involved, and I had just moved to California in 2019, but I was pretty involved in the politics. And this dude was running for president in California on a reparations platform. And nobody, all the people who are now in AASD, Chris Lodson, Friday Jones, like, none of these people I don't think have ever heard of this guy. Right. So where did you come from? I just saw Lord Naheem tweet that said that he had interviewed the brother. And he said something about he's not raising funds, but you can buy his album. Right? So,
What?
Yeah, right? So,
ain't nobody coming to see you, Otis. Ain't nobody trying to buy your album, Otis. Go ahead, brother.
Real shit, real shit. No. No, but it's curious. Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of this popping up. I wanted to actually talk to Marcel when we was out there. I actually ran into him when we were putting together the reparation march in 2021 after Biden was elected, and that brother was just coming into ADOS, and I look up and he is a leading front runner for Congress. I'm saying, all right, bro, do your thing. So I did want to congratulate the brother. But yeah, this idea popping up that a Senate race is minimum $100 million is going to be spent in California. It's probably going to be closer to $750 million for a U.S. Senate race in the state of California. I put up under his pinned tweet, well, bro, what's your ground game like? What's your grass like? What's your team? Who's your campaign manager? How much money have you raised? Right? Because you're running for Senate. We just had a really, really, really bad example of what you do, what happens when you run for Senate and you're not prepared. I'm not going to say no names. but I land there.
We will be having Sunday at church.
Yeah, I believe it's on Brother Max, I think. And then Latasha.
No, I think it was Voltron first.
Oh, yeah. My bad. Oh, yeah. My dog, you know you got it. What's going on, family?
Hey. Good evening, Big B. One salute. Peace and reparations.
To see the Temptations. Ain't nobody coming to see you, Otis. You wish you could work it the way I do.
Go ahead. I had to do it. Go ahead and cook.
Voltron, you on mute, bro.
I'm sorry about that. Can y'all hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you now.
Okay. All right. As I was saying, peace, reparations. Big B wants salute to everybody. Thank you for having me. Harry Tubman's Pistol, Montana, April, much appreciated. And, I got to thank Coops T for hipping me up to the reparations candidate. I was like, reparations candidate in California? Who's this dude? So, I figured, he was going to be kind of like Marcel, But, maybe he doesn't have the groundswell support. And then some red flags start going off. Like, I'm like, who is this nigga? And then I looked at my voter registration pamphlet, and he at the fucking bottom of it and stuff like that. I'm like, who's this Negro? And I was like, okay, let me give him the benefit of the doubt. This, shit happens. And, being a reparations candidate is, it's a tough thing in these United States, especially out here in the San Francisco Bay Area. So I'm getting up in here just listening to this dude. And, he's starting to bore me with this, my campaign, U.S. has $1 quadrillion. I'm like, okay, nigga, this is starting to sound like some old Hoo House bullshit. And I'm just like, nigga, please. All right, quadrillion, nigga, can you count? And then I'm just like, it's starting to get more baffling. And then all of a sudden, he pivoted to get into the gay thing. I'm like, okay, he want to vet Marcel, but Marcel is in South Carolina. Nigga, you in California. Nigga, what you going to do for me? You know, I don't care if you're a reparations candidate, Democrat, Republican, peace and freedom, goddamn it, white supremacists and shit. What you gonna do for me, you know, as a foundational Black American out here in these San Francisco Bay Area, Oakland, California streets? And he just kept going on and on and on and on and on and on about the LGBT thing. And I'm like, does this Negro have children? You know what I'm saying? Everybody here who has children knows that your first examples are going to be the mother and the father. And what the hell are you doing in this goddamn bedroom about this gay thing? You know what I'm saying? You bussymatic too? Is this some, you know, you know, undercover thing you trying to run from, nigga? You got the, you getting all up in this bussyology and shit, nigga. He ain't talked about the LGBT stuff. He's Black first, okay? B1, Black first, reparations, ending qualified immunity, getting these reparations in California. And I'm like, this nigga ain't said nothing about 3121 and stuff. So I'm just getting just like really, really suspicious about this dude. I'm start having a bad feeling. So I'm just listening and listening and listening. And I'm like, I got to say something, you know, and I'm just like, this nigga's embarrassing us. And he from Vallejo too? Nigga, you really embarrassing us as Black folks and stuff. You from the V and you talking like this. Then the Negro has, you know, talking about he co-signed by Lord Jamal. Nigga, I ain't hear you say nothing about 40, you know, from your own hometown. How come E-40 didn't sponsor you? You know, Short? Too Short? The Loonies? I mean, we got some Bay Area artists up here. You know what I'm saying? Out here in the Bay, been independent, been putting in work. Ain't nobody co-signing your shit. And then that nigga had the nerve to tell me, oh, I've been putting in work in this shit. I've been arrested. Nigga, so is half the goddamn, you know, Oakland, California. Nigga, fuck you. You know, shut the fuck up. You know, nigga, so all of us have been arrested. You Black, nigga. You a Black man in these United States. We all been arrested. So fucking what? You know, and they start talking to activist shit. And I just kept getting suspicious, like, all right, we on some Tamika Mallory, Martin Luther Cream, you know, all the rest of these old fake-ass goddamn activists and stuff. And it's just like, I just kept having a bad, bad feeling. I'm just like, this dude's Memorex, man. He ain't live. This nigga's phony like Alexander O'Neal, man. You know what I'm saying? With his hit song, he's a fake. You know, he's a complete fake. I'm just like, you reparations, but you're not talking about reparations. Why weren't you in the New Black Media spaces? Why weren't you in the Secure the Tribe Twitter spaces? Why aren't you online right now talking to all of us here in the Black grassroots? You should be on every goddamn Twitter space that's talking about reparations. And then when I came back the second time, I'm like, okay, well, you at the 3121 listening party over here on 17th Street at the California Ballroom. Then he started babbling. Y'all heard that shit. You know, he was babbling and babbling and babbling, nigga babbling to the fullest. And I'm like, okay, this nigga's phony. All right, he's 100% phony. This nigga's fake as fuck. How are you not in the how are you not following every single reparations meeting? Every listening party. You should be up and down the goddamn state. You know, if you a real reparationist candidate, you can't even show up to some shit in the Bay. It's like, dude, Vallejo only like, you know, 35, 40 miles away. You could have drove on down. Nigga, you could have caught the goddamn bus, okay? You could have caught the Solano bus and got your ass down here to downtown Oakland and just been up in here. But no, you ain't about that reparations life. You ain't for real, nigga. Oh, shit, I just fell. You ain't about that reparations life, man. You phony as fuck. So I'm just not about that, you know, just that fakeness, man. And it's like, he spent 60, 75% of the time talking about Marcel. Did y'all hear any other policies on reparations? I sure didn't.
No, sir. Did
you hear anything about qualified immunity? Right. Right. I heard nothing. And it's just like, oh, you ain't seen my signs. Nigga, AC transit bus signs don't count, partner. You know what I'm saying? You ain't even been no papers, no, nothing online. Don't nobody know you. And you can best believe that nigga didn't say shit to the LGBT lobby out here in San Francisco and Oakland who really running shit out here in the Bay. You best believe he ain't gonna talk that shit to the white folks. I promise you that.
Facts.
He will sit down, keep himself quiet, and ask, boss, can I get some more butter biscuits? you know, to the gay boss. He won't say shit to the goddamn Hollywood lobby. He won't say shit to the LGBT folks in Hollywood. He won't say shit to LGBT folks in Silicon Valley, where that big money's at. We got to recognize when COINTELPRO 2.0 is among us. He was not full-throated in what he said. All he kept repeating is the same fucking talking points.
Did you say full-throated? Y'all is wild. Where'd Drino go?
Go ahead and finish. Just go ahead and finish, Voshan. I'm trying to get to the rest of these rest of the people. You there, bro?
You're on mute, family. I don't know if you know your shit muted.
Well, Harriet Tubman's pistol be fucking shooting, so.
Hey, man, don't blame it on me, man. Blame it on Montana, bro. Quick draw king, quick draw motherfucking, bro. Hey.
Y'all got
two mute-ass niggas as hosts right now.
Man,
it's going to be wild.
I appreciate
it. Hey. We appreciate you, man. We appreciate you going.
Let's do this again. Every single goddamn candidate we got to do the same exact thing. Vet them. Put them to the fire. Make them feel that heat, man. And, you know, you see at the end, he ran like a little biatch. So it's like we got to apply the same pressure to every single candidate we have. It don't matter if it's the mayor, dog catcher, city council person, a state assembly, motherfucking Senate, congresspeople, president. Same exact policy. This is what we should have been doing 50 years ago, 60 years ago in the 60s that our older generation should have did. But we here now. Let's put in work. Continue to do what we're doing, and I loved it. Appreciate y'all. Be one to the fullest.
No problem. If y'all haven't already.
Can I say something about what Black Boltron said? Like, real quick. Best line of the night. When he said, oh, you came from Marcel, you know you done fucked up now. Oh, nigga. Ooh, that shit. That's the fucking truth. That's all I want to say.
I said that?
But how yes, sir, you did. Saying you don't know, you know, where Marcel's staying or what he's about or any of that. And nigga, I ain't seen you at the public hearing. The fuck? Nothing you say after. You can't be running on reparations. And I ain't seen you. Nigga, I've called and made public comment, bitch.
Hello.
I was in Oakland virtually, nigga. What the fuck are we talking about? You cannot be running on that platform and you don't know who Marcel is. Like, I don't know. What the fuck? How is that possible? My God.
The worst part is that he said he didn't know about it. And then it was trying to check me on you. I got to do my homework and study about my candidates. And that nigga didn't even know about the reparations listening party or the meetings. That was the most damning and telling thing that I saw.
Yeah, man. We're going to go to Max, and then we're going to go to Latazio. You know, I got some things to say, but I want to keep the shit flowing because everybody's in this bitch cooking, and I'm enjoying the meal that we're making in this motherfucker. This shit is, I'm goddamn ready for dessert, man. Y'all keep cooking in this motherfucker.
You know what I'm saying? You done fucked up. No, you know that, don't you?
The more questions that cop asks, the more I thought I wasn't going to never see daylight again.
Keep cooking, y'all. You already know. Let's go to Latagia. Then we going to Max. Then we going to Death. Then we going to DJ. Then Padrino.
I guess I'll unmute everybody. Go
my
ahead.
Bad, bro.
Hey, family.
Hey, sorry, Latasia.
Shout out to everybody. Shout out to the host. Shout out to Black Voltron. Shout out to Cherie DC. Shout out to Brother. Oh, God. Shout out to everybody. Shit. I love all y'all. That's all I can say. But basically, y'all done already took all my goddamn talking points. But I will say this. I kind of came in kind of late, and it was like my antennas were going off almost immediately. Never heard of this dude. I Googled him. I didn't. It was pathetic. I didn't see anything that. Well, I mean, it was almost like he was just straight up lying. And what made me crazy or got me thinking, like, really, this dude is retarded, that he would come in here and assault our intelligence. Like, this dude really thought we were stupid. He really thought we was dumb. And the fact that he did not even go to TBA or any of the anybody in the black new media or anything. And then with the Marcel thing, whom I adore, and he was the first and only politician to get my endorsements, I might add, and he earned every bit of it, talking to him personally about my issues. I just found it, first of all, I only knew about the sexuality thing until very recently. I never asked, he never brought it up. I didn't care, nobody cares. So it just was very, really out there, like really, like almost comedic how this dude... How this dude really thought we was stupid in the talking points or lack thereof. It just was really ridiculous. A president, run for president, I never heard of you. Really? Cut it out. I'll land my plan there.
Thanks for your input, sister. We appreciate you.
So actually, Petrino was next. He had to leave and come back.
All right, cool. Let's run. Oh, look, before you go, brother, Before you go, brother, I have a quick announcement to make. If you all haven't already, may y'all please sign a hate crime bill petition that I just put in the Jumbotron. I would really appreciate it. We're trying to get to 2,500 signatures as soon as possible. Then it will get shown, like, from the news. Like, we'll get more media coverage with it. And, yes, we have to keep these type of things at the forefront. I'm going to actually put up another one, like, to call out Narkin and Cobra and make sure that they don't have no place in our reparations advocacy no more. We're not trying to hear from them. They're trying to co-opt us. They're getting paid by people like the MacArthur Foundation or what have you to basically push our reparations down the road or push this weak-ass HR 40, which is nothing but a Trojan horse, so they can grip some more. So I'm going to post that at Jumbotron soon. Let's keep it going. Go ahead, brother.
Yeah, peace. What's going on with y'all? I was just in the live space. You know, it was a little entertaining. I actually checked out the guy with a boy that was running for U.S. Senate for Cali. I can't even remember his name, but I saw his interview that he did a couple weeks back on Lord Jamar, and then the interview that he did on Sy Nutter. And two things that was alarming was that when you listen to his reparations plan, it doesn't make sense. Like, the nigga just talking, so it's kind of like soapbox shit. Like, yo, this is what I'm trying to do, and this is what I'm... So, like, damn, you know what I'm saying? So it's kind of like you feel bad because, like, you don't want to say, like, he on some bullshit, but we got to keep it a bean. Like, he just a nigga that just heard of reparations probably and been like, yo, this some cool shit. I know niggas will fuck with it. Because, like, when you really listen to him, the stuff that he's really pushing is anti-LGBTQ shit. Which, again, I mean, policy-wise, nothing is wrong with that. But if you actually listen, it's like this nigga got an ideology like the Moors or the Israelites, and his ideology is anti-LGBTQism. Like, that's his... I wouldn't be surprised if that nigga was, like, a Moor or some shit like that. But
he did say Yahweh.
Listen, he might be an Israel. Listen, I'm telling you, but I say that to say this, you know. It's these different people, you know. I think the brother Devon was saying, is this guy stupid or is he an agent? I think he just stupid. And the reason why I say that is that I just don't think he understands, like, really what's going on. One of the reasons why he probably ain't been on the, like, the new black media. One of the reasons why he was on Sy Nutter and Lord Jamar is because that nigga rap, I guess. So he looking at it like, oh, shocking, just the little angle that I can get through. I don't think that nigga really understand the political complex. And, like, I don't think he understand the grassroots shit. I don't even think he know that there's a reparations movement going on. Now, that nigga don't know there's a reparations movement going on. This nigga didn't even show up in Cali. So, yeah, man, you can't give a nigga like that the benefit of the doubt because he ain't doing his research. But it's unfortunate. I'm glad niggas called him out. Yeah, it's some riders over here, man. I ain't going to hold you. Y'all be doing y'all thing. So, yeah, niggas keep that good shit up, man.
This what we do, brother. This what we do. And speaking of that, that brings us to our sponsors, the United States Immigration and Customs Enforcement Agency, all right? That number is 866-DHS-2ICE. Call ICE and call them twice. That number again is 1-866-347-2423. A message from our sponsors. Y'all already know. ICE. already know. Call ICE and call them twice. All right? Some message from our sponsors. Please stand by.
Hey, you know, it's crazy because, and I just want to say this real quick, like, that's why I wasn't really into Twitter, you know what I'm saying, before tapping into the grassroots media. Shout out to y'all. But, bro, Twitter tell it all. You know what I'm saying? You can't, bro. I went on your timeline, and your timeline is going to tell me what you tapped in. You're not talking about nothing about the Buffalo Massacre. You're not talking about nothing about Marcel. You're not talking about nothing about California reparations. You're not talking about nothing about Mason, Tennessee. You ain't been tapped in into nothing. You're not talking about the American Maroon. You're not talking about nothing. You don't got nothing on your platform that says that you've been tapped into what's going on out here in the grassroots. And you want to come for somebody who really, I mean, takes time out of their day. I mean, be up. Marcel done been up 2, 3 o'clock in the morning before. You know what I'm saying? Going back and forth. Hey, I got to drop somebody so I can bring him up. Dang, that was a beautiful request. Somebody slide down so we can get Dion up here.
I'll drop it quick.
You know I ain't finna drop down. You gonna have to drop my ass. Fuck you talking about? I ain't going no goddamn where.
Me neither. Fuck that.
Yeah, and before he go, you know what I'm saying? I'm just gonna say this. You know, it's funny that my boy been talking about, nobody's talking about continuous checks. You know what I'm saying? Back to back to back. I'm like, yeah, everybody go read From Here to Equality. The number is 151 million per Black American. You know what I'm saying? 2.5 million for 70 years, checks and land. It's already been done. You know what I'm saying? It's all the numbers and the science has already been put, you know what I'm saying, into place. You know, so respectfully, it's on Max. It's on you, family.
Do you want me to go or should we let Dion?
No, you going.
You got it, Max.
Yeah, you've been waiting patiently. Been a motherfucker. You've been out there here for a minute. Do your thing.
Well, this is perfect because, Dion, there's a lot I wanted to say to you on the other talk, but I didn't.
Let it out, brother. Let it out.
But I got to say, this was the first time I heard about you. And the entire time I wanted to vote for you. I got to be honest. I ran and opened up my ballot because of you. And I'm looking at it, and I see that everyone else has a party affiliation and what their job is, but yours is the only one that, you know, it just says none, which is okay. I mean, that stands out. And just so you know, I've run for local government before. I'm here in Menlo Park. But, man, like, I didn't get sponsored ads. I didn't get anything. You didn't even reach out to me, and I'm pretty plugged in with political folks out here. And I'm like, dude, this is the first time I heard about you. But the thing that really, really got me is that, bro, I was at the reparations meeting. And when you talked and said, like, you didn't hear about it, I'm like, bro, the parking was free. Like, the parking was free, bro. And it's reparations. This was a historic moment. Why? Bro, I was tired. I'm a professional triathlete. I biked 2 hours, and I was debating if I should go or not. I was so tired. I was wondering if I should take a nap. And I was like, you know what? I need to go there because I understand my history. My great grandfather was a sharecropper. My grandfather then went to Tuskegee and then started his own church. So I was like, you know what? Doesn't matter how tired I am, I need to go there. So I am just very disappointed in you, as well as I'm also disappointed in myself, because I'm like, Dan, dude, if you got your name on the ballot, why isn't my name on the ballot? And I'm not going to vote for you, bro. Dion, I'm not going to vote for you, because if anything, I'm going to write my name in and thank you for inspiring me, because I've been here. I've been putting in the work. I've got receipts. But, bro, this isn't for you. And just respectfully, like, I would love to support you in any other way. You know, I'm here in the Bay Area, but this is a good time for you to maybe get some feedback and just learn from us.
And hold up, I'm running this space different. I want to hear from the people. That's one thing about the other space. No disrespect, that I want to do. I want to hear from the people. So I'm gonna clear these people out. Let my brothers and sisters speak and say their piece. And Dion, if you want to respond to any of these people after this, my brothers and sisters in the grassroots, then you're welcome to do so after that. But I want to hear from the people. You're a potential constituents, which not looking too good, bro. But you get what I'm saying. Go ahead. We're gonna go to Jeff. Yeah, because you've been up here. All right, go ahead. All right, I unmuted you. Go ahead, bro.
All right, yeah. Yeah, thanks for hosting.
Oh, you good there, fat brother? You go ahead.
Yep. Yeah, I'm about to fall asleep, so I'm glad you picked on me. So since Dion is here, you know, I was first introduced to you. I saw your interview with Sy Netter. And, you know, I hope you weren't reading the comment section because, you know, they were flaming you in that comment section. I mean, the biggest problem we have with you is you don't accept constructive criticism. And, like, you know, I'm not a fan of IQ tests, but, I mean, we might need to throw one at you. That's all I'm saying. Like, what's going on here? Like, it's like, you know, they say if one person is an asshole during your day, you know, maybe that person is an asshole, but if everybody during your whole day was an asshole to you, you might be the asshole. And I'm going to land there because I'm tired.
Appreciate your input, brother. I'm going to go to, let's go to Veronica next.
Hey, and everybody, please tweet out the space because you know how they be doing this. You know, they be trying to blacklist us. So everybody take a moment to tweet out the space. You know, let's get all the family in here so everybody can talk to Dion and he can talk to the grassroots and we can, you know, get some shit ironed out, you know, because that's all it's about. Communication builds a nation.
Boy, we need to get some political straightening. All right. So this is the order. We're going to go to DJ, Veronica, then we're going to go to Corey because I know them three been up here a long time specifically. All right. Then we're going to go to B-Man, Ogun, and then Yikes. All right. And then we'll go from there.
And those that requested will definitely get you up here. Okay, everybody, for sure. Go ahead, Mom, Miss Veronica. You good verified sis, you. Go ahead.
I'd like to say hello to everyone and be one first. I tried to keep a constructive attitude about what happened. The bottom line is the guy didn't sound like he was ready for prime time. And actually, he made me even more proud of Marcel. He wasn't good on his feet. He became defensive. And that's not a good look for anybody, not even just for Black people, period. When we come somewhere, we need to be prepared. You need to know your audience. Get off your talking points. Respond and react to your audience. But also, I think I really advise you need to probably get some help, get a coach, and don't act intimidated. Stand firm on what you believe. It was really disappointing just to see that you were a Black man up there speaking. And of course we had Vin and Marcel. We wouldn't have had him up there if he wasn't what he was. And you just weren't ready for prime time. Hey, drop me. You guys have a great evening. And I have to go, but I just wanted to say my piece.
Thanks for your input, sister. We really appreciate it. DJ, it's on you.
Yeah, peace and reparations, everybody. Black first. So basically, to make a long story short, I have heard of this brother Dion, and he has ran for so-called president back, whatever, 2016. And yeah, K-Slate did vet him or whatever the case be, but K-Slate brother, you know, rest in peace of that brother, he ain't political. You know what I mean? Lil Jamal definitely ain't political. If he's saying that reparations is due also to Black people that just got here yesterday from Africa and came off an actual plane and not a slave ship, you crazy as hell, dog. You know what I'm saying? Busta Rhymes is a tether. We don't care. You know what I'm saying? When you talk hip hop, I don't want to hear none of that shit, bro. Because that shit was started here in the fucking Bronx. Our Black ancestors was fucking stopping on these Jews and these fucking Italians just to go to the disco, dog. You know what I'm saying? So I don't want to hear nobody that's in hip hop saying they vetted you. Because we real reparationists, we put them in their place too. Just like you got put in your place tonight. How you not know about AB 3121, even though you said, yeah, you didn't know? I'm from over here in Newark, New Jersey. I know about that, bro. You feel what I'm saying? You feel me? That's some real shit. I'm constantly looking at California. You know what I mean? Constantly. like my Angela, my sister Angela Nirvana say, the reparations perspective. If California goes, so does the nation, bro. You know what the fuck that means? Y'all got the number one fucking GDP, nigga, out of all the states, man. You know what I'm saying? I think Jersey is like 3 or 4, some shit like that. Because I know we get money out here, nigga. You know what I'm saying? So I already know that shit. You know what I mean? Other thing is, who gives a fuck if Marcel fucking fuck with another nigga? I don't give a fuck about that shit, bro. If reparations wouldn't be here on the national stage, just keep it real. But one for people like Yvette Carnell, you know what I'm saying? She brought this shit to all our attention, in my opinion. And she gave, but she never even mentioned anything as far as like legislation for LGBTQ or none of that shit. Know what I mean? Never mentioned anything. And she always said, fuck them niggas too. You know what I'm saying? I'm riding with my black people. Know what I'm saying? If you want to crack on me because I'm whatever, know what I'm saying? Then what is? That shit ain't no fucking slide off my fucking back. Reparations first. Know what I mean? So if you ain't really in this shit full chest, and it's not the Joan on you or clown you or anything like that, we want to big you up. But if you're going to be one of them hard-headed Negroes, and black people hard-headed as motherfucker, especially my African homies, you know what I'm saying? Y'all Negroes be hard-headed as hell, don't want to listen to shit, and you always think a nigga wrong. You know what I'm saying? I spent my life hustling CDs out here in the corner in front of a liquor store too, friend. You know what I'm saying? And niggas know who I am, and they know I talk this shit. They tell me all the time, you need to run for mayor. Nah, I don't give a fuck about that shit, because when I start running, somebody got to get hurt. You know what I'm saying? Because that's how it is out here in Jersey, bro. You know what I mean? I ain't trying to risk my neck for niggas that ain't really going, I know ain't going to back me. You feel what I'm saying? Even though I know the data. And I'll yield my plane there, I guess. You know what I mean?
Thanks for your input, brother.
Let's not aggregate or, you know, excuse me, get with any type of celebrities like Luke. We told Luke 2 or 3 years ago not to vote for Kamala. And you see what he's doing to us. You feel what I'm saying? We're showing this brother the information. Look, this is what it is, bro. And we told you that 2 or 3 years ago, and you told us to shut up. You told ADOS to shut up. That's what you said, Luke. So all y'all hopping in his Twitter spaces, y'all got to cut that shit out too, y'all. F these celebrities. They boule. Look up the boule. Do your history on the boule. They all boule. They will never come help us, man. I'm in this space for real. I got 30 years audio engineering. Real shit. I've been seeing it, but I know you did. Thank you.
And all I just want to say real quick that Luke is a whole tether. Okay.
And I just want to say, I'm just doubling down on what my dog said, because, you know, I'm from Atlanta, you know what I'm saying? And even though I'm from Atlanta and I tapped into the Minnesota reparations out here because I was in Minnesota and I knew it was going on. And I tapped in with my dog, B-Man, that's out here in Minnesota, that's right here up under me. And we went up there and made sure that the message was passed out. So I don't understand how somebody running in California don't know what's going on in California when I'm not even from California and I know what's going on. And I got text messages to all my family, that all my folks and all my partners that's in California, said, like y'all don't know what's going on out there, but you need to tap in, do your genealogy, get back to 18, blase, blase, look up AB 3121, send them videos, send them the live chat. I got everybody that I know that's out there, you know what I'm saying? Because I got folks out there that's in Oakland and shit like that, and I'm sending them all the information. So, you know, it's just, but I'm letting everybody else talk. Y'all go ahead, family.
I gotta go to Sharia. Yo. Sorry, y'all. I gotta go.
No, no, come back. Come back after this.
Okay. All right, cool. All right, cool. Then we gonna go to B-Man. Matter of fact, hold on.
No, it was me.
Yeah, I think it was Corey, and then I think it was Black Majority State, then B-Man, then Yikes, then Coops, then Black Voltron. Then
hold on, Montana. Don't put me all way the fuck.
I ain't gonna be long because the brother DJ basically said what I was gonna say. Lord Jamar, you brother Dion, you said that Lord Jamar is 100% on coke. That's a lie. I mean, the lie detector determined that's a lie. Lord Jamar he don't speak much. He don't represent FBA. You know what I mean? He had an issue with FBA. So when you say he 100% on coke, I don't care what he sponsored you. That man ain't for the people because his folks ain't from here. Yeah, man. So I want to put that out there. Shout out to the family. Shout out to Harry with the motherfucking pistol. Yeah, man. I'm laying right there.
Thanks, family. And I apologize. We losing order and stuff here. So it's been a lot of people, and we just trying to keep everything flowing. Appreciate all y'all input. Hey, Dion, bro. Hey, respectfully, bro. You feel me? I got to let my people cook. You feel me? Like, you got to hear it from the grassroots, man. We saying everything that we wasn't able to say, and it's the real. All right, so we gonna go to
go ahead. No, you got it, family. You got it.
I want to go to I honestly want to go to Ogun because I know he's been sitting here for a minute. B man, you know he be here, so we gonna go to Ogun. B man, then we gonna go to Yikes, then we gonna go to Coops, and then Claire. That's gonna be the order.
Yeah, B1 family. Thanks for letting me come in and drop mine. What I want to say is because
hold on one moment, and I'm not gonna accept no more speakers until we clear so we can keep this flowing properly, y'all. All right.
Good looking, fam. So when I heard Dion come in, and I was listening in that room for over an hour, and the thing about it is, man, what I didn't appreciate is because when you were explaining your ten things that will be a deal breaker, and your last one happened to be the LGBT, you didn't even have to mention Marcel. You didn't have to stop and say, you know, and this last one is going, you know, going to do something to somebody. And a matter of fact, one of your candidates is running. You didn't have to put Marcel in anything that you had going on because, again, you running for California. You ain't got nothing to do with Marcel. Marcel popped in the room because he popped in the room. You brought Marcel and his sexuality into it. And now we're telling you, why the fuck aren't you? Why are you worrying about that and not worried about what California is going to get? Why are you worried about what he got going on in his bedroom when he running off the same thing you're running off of, supposedly, and that's reparations? Now, another thing that got me was when you said that if the brother gets in Congress, you would have to work with him. No, you don't. No, you don't. You can just be as whatever you are now as if he does get in Congress. Because right now you're hell bent on telling everybody that you're not going to support him and you don't want no support on him. So anything that comes out of supporting Marcel should not benefit you. And my last question is, if Marcel gets in through the grassroots, which he will, and that check starts to come through and you see a check on your name, are you going to cash that check? And are you violating yourself by doing that? And I'll land there.
All right, we're gonna keep it flowing. Next person. So we're gonna go to B Man, then Yikes, then Coops, then Claire.
All right, what's up, y'all, man? Hey, man, that was. Thank y'all for holding it down, man. In that space, there's a couple things, Dion. I'm glad that you're in here, so we can, you know, you can hear exactly what I'm talking about. And I don't know, maybe, you know, I played and coached football a lot. So, you know, in a football game and you take an L, you will break down every single play. You'll go back play by play. You'll look at the steps, see if people move the right way. You'll look at the mistakes that were made, who did something good, who could have been better in other areas. Maybe you can take some of this stuff and you could do it on your own. Maybe you'll replay back this conversation as well as the other one in the other space. And correct some things, but there's a couple things, man, that just stick out to me that don't sit right. Like, number one, you was talking about you ran in 2016, and all I hear you talking about is I. Bro, you supposed to be for the people. So you ran in 2016, and you mean to tell me since 2016, the New Black Media has been stomping these streets with this shit. You mean to tell me from 2016 to 2022, you ain't had no chance to get on in touch with Jason Black, Tariq? You ain't touched with Professor Black Truth? I mean, you mentioned that you talked to Dr. Claude, or no, that you read Dr. Claude Anderson's book. You didn't speak to the nigga? Like, what is going on, bro? Like, are you just doing your own thing? Or are you really out here trying to do something for the people, bro? We can see right through that shit, man. And that shit just don't sit well, bro. That shit don't sit well at all. And then, shout out to Red Joker, because he started pulling your motherfucking receipts, bro. Is you rapping?
I love Red Joker.
Is you rapping, or are you hanging out with Tone Tits? What the fuck is going on? I pick up the mic right now, nigga. Have you worked with Tone and Yvette? Answer that question. Harriet, let him answer that question right now. I got to know.
Am I allowed to talk now?
Yes, you allowed, bro. Big Stepper B-Man, bro. Hey, yo.
Yvette and Antonio Moore blocked me on Twitter because they do not like my stance on anything. I've tried to reach out to everybody. I reached out to every single person you listen to in the grassroots movement. I actually bought some ads on Tariq Nasheed years ago, telling everybody I was about to run for president again under my hip hop name because I'm a grassroots hip hop organizer. I bought ads that's verified. You could go back on Tariq Nasheed's radio channel and hear my ads being ran with him saying Alpha Leo running for president in 2020 for reparations. Can I talk to these guys? No. I've reached out to Jason Black. I've reached out to Tariq Nasheed. I've reached out to these guys. I was on Tariq Nasheed's Twitter space about a few weeks ago. I told him about my DMLG package. He liked it. He said, yes, this is good. You know, he told me to hit him up. I haven't got a response yet, but that was only about a couple of weeks ago, right? So, you know, if you go back and if you've been paying attention, you see my fingerprints all over. I don't have 100,000 subs on YouTube yet, but you know, I mean, I think we get too caught up on popularity. And I want to answer a few questions because, and I'm not, you know, anybody who have any type of concerns, you're supposed to have concerns. You are supposed to vet me. But one thing I don't like is when my words are being misconstrued. I made it clear in my reparations package that $3.1 million and all of that, that's an at least factor. It's at least, I came up with a lowball number that everybody can agree to. Okay, so I can say that we have at least 10 million people who we can all agree that can prove that they are blacks who descended from American slaves. That is a fact. I stated that in mad publications. I've said it over and over again, but for some reason, people keep hanging this. Oh, you're saying we only get 3.1 million. And far as the armed forces, name me somebody who talked about reparations as an armed force. That's something you nobody ever heard of. And I'm not trying to pat myself on the back, but I have to, you know, defend myself because it's so many misinterpretations and misunderstandings about my policies and what I stand for as a black person running for Congress, running for Senate right now. So,
hey, so with that, you're running for Senate right now, but what is the name of your website? How do I get to it? What does it say?
I have www.reparationsforpresident.com, and I have www.deondjenkinsforpresident.com.
And that's where we're going to stop it. All right, yeah. I want to get to the people. We done heard a lot from you, respectfully, bro. We gonna go to my sister Sheree because she clearly got something to say. And we gonna go to my sister Yikes, then Coops, and then Claire.
Yeah, real quick. So no, this isn't about popularity, bro. Okay, I just want to make sure that's clear. This ain't a popularity contest or none of that, nigga. You supposed to been campaigning, and people should have known who you were. What are you talking about? AB 31 has happened every month for almost a year, for 8, 9, 10 months, and you never showed up once. You never called in once. You didn't even show up at the public hearing at the church. What are you talking about? This is not about being popular, bruh. This is about how you claim that you are running on a reparations platform in fucking California, and no one knows who you are that are active reparationists on the ground, your constituents, people that actually are there with you, do not know who you are on our platform, bro. This ain't got nothing about popularity, because you know what? Tariq and them wasn't calling Marcel either. That nigga got out here in the fucking grits with us. You feel what I'm saying? Like, he been on the ground. He been showing up. Like, he, like, for real, bro. I'm confused as how you equated any of what we're talking about to a popularity contest when you are running and should be campaigning. You should be popular as
fuck right now. We should know who you are when you're running on a reparations platform in the state that has the reparation law plastic. When we gained lineage base only, where was your brother? You could have did a YouTube then. We would have all pulled. We anybody talk about reparations, I'm pulling up. I don't care if it's a white man, a white woman, a black man, a black woman. If reparations, I get on Twitter and put that in the search because I want to see who talking about it, brother. You have not been talking about it. So I don't know how it's your platform. This ain't about, you should be popular. You should be, especially if you're running on reparations in California, brother. What are we doing? Oh my God. Go ahead, Sheree. Oh my goodness.
Hello. Hey, if Sheree's sitting there for a second, if you ain't gonna go real quick, I just want to say, no. I'm gonna hold it. Go ahead, Sheree. I know you're right. Go ahead. If not, we can go down to Sister Yikes.
I'm sorry, did y'all say my name yet? I'm just waiting patiently.
Yes, it's your turn, Sister Sheree. It's your turn.
Okay. I just want to ask because as we've been getting...
Nigga.
Hey, hold up, bro. The fire alarm going on. Hey, the smoke alarm going on, bro. Y'all in here cooking, bro. Hold up. All right, hold up. Let me get this. All right, go ahead.
Look, goddammit, don't you fucking cut me off, niggas. All right, look, I'm gonna put a pin in that. I'm gonna put a pin in that. We're gonna come back to that. All right. Hey, bro, nigga, we're gonna have to talk later. Anyway, I just wanna say, nigga, Dion, where your great grandmama from? Where your people from? Cause look, number one, we talking about putting black first, and we know that black people are here, foundational black Americans, descendants of American chattel slavery. We the only black people on this fucking earth. Okay, I just want to know, for my own peace of mind, where do you descend from? You said you running in California, so where is your great grandmama from? Do you know? If you don't know, I'm a genealogist. I can help you. Okay, but that part we have not got into. And that's number one. We're delineating. We're separating ourselves. It ain't just black everybody who's fucking melanated that you're in this conversation. No. We're talking about foundational black Americans. People who descended from chattel slavery. Freed fucking men and women. Okay, so, brother, I didn't ask you that before. And that's literally number one question. So I'm asking you now. Where do you descend from? Where is your grandmama from? Where your great grandmama from? Thank you.
Yes, that's a great question. So, on my grandmother's side, and my particular grandmother on my mom's side, they are from Louisiana. All right, and they came, and we have a long history from Louisiana, and then they migrated to California. Her and my great grandfather migrated out here to California, and they began to procreate. And on my father's side is from Oklahoma. So yeah, that's that.
Dion, you got Indian in your family?
Native American, I heard something like that. Yes, I probably do. I probably have some Native American in my family. Yes, I do.
Okay, I'm going to put a pin in that for now, but thank you for answering. I can move on.
All right, let's go to Yikes.
Thank you for letting me speak, Harry Tubman's Pistol. And I spoke earlier, Mr. Dion, and I spoke on how you really made my head hurt in that last space. I just want to say, I mean, I am an alphabet person. That's what they call me in the spaces because my issues are not that important as it pertains to what's going on in my personal life. Okay. But, I'm also, I don't know what my exact lineage is, but I just returned back from Buffalo.
Holler at me, sis. I'm gonna get you right.
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely. And I would appreciate it. I really appreciate it. I would like to go through a vehicle that's non-white if you don't. You know what I'm saying? I just can't trust them. So
I got you, bro.
Yes. I just got back from Buffalo today. This whole past week, I've spent in going around New York a little bit just to get a little more information, but also to do some other things and donate, of course. But I just couldn't believe hearing you go for Brother Marcel when he's doing so much for the grassroots. He's on here all the time. I hear about him all the time. And today, you actually revealed to me that he is also what you would consider an alphabet person, or what they call him. I had no clue. I had no idea that was what he had going on, because I never really cared. When I get on the internet and I look up Marcel, most of his debates are about the Freedmen, and it's about trying to get foundational Black Americans what they're owed in this country, okay? I find it just shocking that you could get up there and bring out that part of him when he doesn't mention it. None of his debates, not one. I've never seen it, and I was so shocked that you would even bring that. It's kind of a low blow, sir. And I'm trying to explain it to you in a way that you might understand, is that regardless of what's going on in somebody's personal life, and I think that maybe it's kind of going beyond you. You know what I'm saying? It's going over your head that I do have a personal life, but I also have beliefs that I act on. You know what I'm saying? It's not necessarily one negates the other. So I wanted to bring this up again when I said it earlier, that if this was a conversation about being Protestant and Catholic, and it was only Protestants who were Black in America and who were foundational Black Americans, we wouldn't be having this conversation, because you would accept them as a Christian either way. I'm just saying, what your whole argument is very convoluted, okay? And I just want to say this as well, okay? You had an opportunity tonight to win the hearts of the grassroots by bringing your platform to the people. And instead, you chose to argue a moot point that's just basically not on code. You're not on code when you say this. Black first means be one. It's in the name. I don't, we can't get it mixed up. And that's where these white people and these coons succeed in derailing the conversations about reparations. When you bring up dumb things like whatever Marcel has going on in his personal life, especially when you actually running for an office, it's embarrassing. And we don't need someone bringing more light to the fringe issues like alphabet rights. Okay, I don't bring no light to that. I don't say none of that on my profile. I talk about what's really going on. We talking about the relation for all these shootings that's going on, and how the Black people are being targeted. And we trying to get the reparations to the forefront. So you got to put your personal preference to the side. You know what I'm saying? Just like I put mine to the side when I pull up the Buffalo. You know what I'm saying? And also, it's not about a popularity contest. It's about populating the Black grassroots with more Black people who don't know their grassroots and who are on code. So you're not on code. And it's not rocket science. And these folks are pulling your card because you're unaware of the situation, A, or you're doing it to derail us, B. So on the ground, and despite the fact that you're saying you're doing groundwork, because you're missing out on all these people who actually doing the work, sir. It's contradicting everything you say. I'm going to land there, and I'm just leaving it there.
And you Thanks. Know, it's crazy, and I just want to double back, because, you know, when I follow Yikes, look at her profile, I don't know that she's gay or whatever the case. I don't know what her sexual preference is. I don't care, and that's not what I'm looking for. That's not, it doesn't matter, you know what I'm saying? And I definitely agree with, we need strong men in the community, you know what I'm saying? I was raised by my father, you know what I'm saying? That's my dog, you know what I'm saying? And man, I look up to that man like I can't replace him, you know what I'm saying? I understand our relationship is something that's just dear to me, you know what I'm saying? But that has nothing to do with, you know what I'm saying, a person that is not putting their sexuality first, you know what I'm saying? Because you can't be one or the other. You can't be reparations first and LGBTQ first. You can't do that. You know what I'm saying? It's one or the other. So if we have people that's reparations, that's B1, Black first, that's standing on that, you're not going to see that tied intertwined with anything that's a brown, Black and brown coalition, anything that's an LGBTQ coalition, anything that has to do with anything about a Pan-African coalition with everybody getting... No, you're not going to see that. It's very specific for, you know what I'm saying, the people. And if that's what you're standing on and that's what you're stepping with, then that's what I'm standing on. That's what I'm stepping with. And respectfully, we can stand and step. You know what I'm saying? I don't give a damn. You know what I'm saying? I don't care. You know, about what a person's sexual preference is, or their religion, or their gang affiliation, or anything like that. I don't care. You know what I'm saying? Because I need all the geeks. I need all the gangsters. I need all the gays. I need all everybody that we need. I need all the men. I need all the women. You know what I'm saying? We delineating and aggregation. You know what I'm saying? Communication, reparations is going to change this motherfucking nation. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it's all about, family. Y'all go ahead.
All right, so let's go to we're going to Coops next, then Claire, then we're gonna go to Black Majority, then back to Voltron.
Yeah, peace and Black Power, family. Peace, love, and reparations. And thank you for holding the space. Thank you, Harriet, and B1 family. My God, I was on hold for so long in that other space. I didn't even get to come up, but y'all have already brought my points up this late date, which is fine. Because now my pressure is gone down. But I do have a couple of questions for Dion. Yeah, I see you still in the space. I do have a couple of questions, and I want to take Cherie's question a little bit further. She asked about your great-grandmom on your mom and dad's side, great-granddad. And I got what you said about Oklahoma and Louisiana, but I want to know a little more specifically if you can answer this question. Do you have any of anyone in your lineage or in your ancestors that have come from the Caribbean that have come to the States from the West Indies or anything like that? That's my question, number one. Number two, I wanted to know Dion's, I didn't hear him say anything about immigration. And I wanted to know what his stance is on immigration and especially how it, you know, affects Black Americans, FBA. So that's my second question. Right. And go ahead and answer those first, bro, before I get too far into it. I want to know if you have family from the West Indies or from the Caribbean, Africa, so forth, and then what your stance is on immigration. Then I'll go after you.
Right. Yeah, no, I have ancestry from the plantations. Going back, like I said, from Louisiana and Oklahoma. I've been to family reunions as a little child. So that's how I know. And also the second question that you asked. Hold on, what's the second question?
My bad. I want to know what your stance is on immigration since you run.
Exactly. So right now I'm running against a guy who's trying to legalize 5 million illegal immigrants. So that would be a huge problem. That would completely wipe us out in California. We're already being wiped out in California. The gentrification is extremely on high status out here. People are moving out of Oakland. Black Voltron, he's from Oakland. People are being moved out in all types of areas out here. They're moving to Stockton, Vallejo, where I live. They're move into like the inner parts, Modesto, and Merced, and all types of inner city areas that I don't like to say inner city, but more inland, away from the bigger cities and the metropolitan areas. So yes, that's a huge problem, and we have to have representatives who are willing to combat that.
Okay. Thank you. I'm okay with that there. Yeah, I'm from Oakland too, born and raised. And right. Matter of fact, my oldest daughter lives in Vallejo. I got right. one in Sacramento, son in San Jose. Right. And most of my family on my mom's side is in Oakland, Berkeley. Yes. And I graduated from the peninsula. So, you know, all what that is. Right. Yeah, I just wasn't really feeling where you were coming from mm-hmm. with your stance, taking that hard line on the LGBTQ situation. I mean, I'm a Black familyist. I believe in the Black family. I believe in a strong Black family. But I'm not going to have a candidate or I'm not going to vote for anybody that, is going to take such a hard stance with that and not come forth with reparations. voting for a pastor. You sound like you need to be in the church with that. That really, to be honest, and I'm not going to put my vote for you because you're not coming full chested with reparations, in my opinion. You more full chested with being anti-gay, and I really don't appreciate it. I'm not gay, but I'm just saying that's not what we're here for. So right. I just let you know, yeah, you losing your constituents, and I really did not appreciate when you came forth with, well, you don't have to vote for me. Okay, yeah. Because I'm letting you know I'm not voting for you, and right. I'm from the Bay Area. So this is what's going on. I want you to think about this. This is what's going on. So I'll go ahead and land my plane there.
Yeah, you know, like me, you know, I made it clear that I'm a reparations candidate, and I constructed the four elements of reparations, and I consistently been on that path, and I promised everybody that. Once elected, the first thing I'm going to do is create legislation for that. However, I am an anti-LGBT candidate as well. So I'm going to take away a lot of the, once I'm in there, I'm going to take away a lot of the protections that they have benefited off of our blood and off of our ancestors. Excuse me, it's late. And I'm going to give those rights back to us, because we don't benefit off of the rights that our ancestors have died for. And I made that very clear, and we need more enforcement of the law, and we're not being, the 14th Amendment Equal Protection Clause is not being upheld in the Constitution by the defensive structure in our society. So yes, as a candidate, I am going to pull away any type of protections for the LGBT community. And I'm going to give those protections back to Black people who descended from American slaves, you know, reparations all day.
All right, let's go to Sister Claire. Then we're going to go to Voltron. Then we're going to go to Black Majority. And then back to B-Man. I apologize. No, then we're gonna go to Pro. All right, go ahead. Claire, you there?
Clarice.
I got you, Eve. All right.
We gotta keep it going.
You, sister, I see you came off the mic, but I don't know if they got matrix.
All right, then let's go to Voltron.
Hey, Black Majority was before me, so I'm gonna use
all right, that's fine.
Okay, man, I really appreciate that. I wanted to speak to the gentleman in the space, but obviously they weren't letting anybody up to speak, So Dion, I just think you're conflating a lot of issues, and I think you're more confused than you actually may realize. And so I want to break it down, your stance, because it's a firm stance. It kind of fits into the Republican side of politics, right wing side of politics. A lot of very racist people hold that view. That's their stance, but I just want to separate it for you a little bit. So I post a lot against white feminism. White feminazis is what I call them, because that's what they are. I post a lot against the LGBTQ community in terms of, you know, their weaponization against Black Americans. But here's something that you got to understand. Just like Black feminism is not the same as white feminism, the same is true for Black LGBTQs. They are not the same as the white LGBTQs. The issue is that the Democrat Party has really been funding and weaponizing a very small but very loud percentage of Black feminists and Black LGBTQs against Black America politically. And I think that's the group that you may be trying to target. I think the problem with that is that, you know, there's could be as many as 5, 6, 7% of our community that actually self-identifies as LGBTQ. I have members of my family that are gay or lesbian. Growing up on my street, there were kids that were gay at a very young age. Some of my best friends, to be perfectly honest. I think most of us have cousins or some relative that we love dearly that may identify with this community. So you taking a hard stance against a political vehicle, but you're actually shutting out members of our entire community. And that's the problem. And I think people were really being graceful to you and trying to give you the opportunity to, first of all, stop attacking Marcel, because obviously, if you read the room, everybody in that room was there to support him. I support him with everything. And I think everybody feels the same way. So as a politician, no matter what room you're in, part of your job is to read the room. No matter what your stance is, you take that stance, you put it to the side, and then you focus on the issues. And people kept giving you opportunity after opportunity to just focus on the issue. But every time you spoke, you came back to this stance. And again, you just got to separate the stance, because there's a lot of nuance in that stance that you're not really understanding. And I hope that you get that education. I hope you seek out the opportunity to really dig into it and understand you have to protect all Black Americans no matter what. And I'll end with that.
Yeah. I never said that I wasn't going to protect them. I said that I'm a take away protections, meaning that you cannot get benefits because you're gay. Just like I can't get any benefits because I'm straight. I can't get benefits and protections. If I'm walking down the street as a straight man, there's no benefits I get just for being a straight man. Your sexuality have nothing to do with your equal protection clause. And I think that's the whole issue that people are not understanding when it comes to my stance. I'm not saying that I'm going to take away rights as far as.
Well, real quick, family, because we got a lot of family in here that want to speak respectfully. And I just want to say, nah, bro, we understand that. I think you not understanding is what we saying is that we understand that that's an issue. We understand that. We get that that's the issue. And most of us and a lot of us, I mean, definitely support that stance. You know what I'm saying? And if you were tapped into the grassroots for real, you would understand that you would be a part of the conversations that we have and that we have had with the LGBTQ community, letting them know that we do not support the LGBTQ, that whole establishment, because they support establishments like GLAAD and things like that that have anti-Black agenda. So if you're standing with a whole community that has anti-Black agendas, you know what I'm saying? But that doesn't mean that if you're Black and you're lesbian, or you're Black and you're gay, and you're Black and you're trans, that's two totally different things. That's not aligning yourself with my enemy. Now, if you're going to align yourself with my enemy and you're not going to be Black first, and then you're going to turn around and try to use your Black card in order to get some type of support or some type of, you know, like Jussie Smollett, Juicy Smoothie. No. We're not with none of that. And I definitely agree with you. But if you're on a Black first agenda, be one, you know what I'm saying? If that's your agenda, if that's what you stand on, if that's what you're pushing, I don't care about everything else we can work out. Everything else we can sit around and talk about, unless you're not messing with them kids, you're not murdering my people, and you're not stealing. Those are principles. Everything else we can really work out. I can agree to disagree, and we can sit down and we can talk about policies and doing all that other stuff. You know what I'm saying? But when you're coming into a room with people, I think, shout out to Security Sheree DC, because she said it the best. When you say the word reparations, I'm 10 times in your ass now. You know what I'm saying? Now I'm really on you, and now I really got to pull up everything that you're talking about, because we have to make sure that we all on the same page. And that's why you got to just come tap in with the grassroots, and you should be humbling yourself to learn. Because when you start talking about, well, I'm the only person that talks about having a military to protect, I'm like, no. Because we already have conversations. If you have over 30 acres and you have the land, the deed to the land, you can put up your own executive protection services. You don't have to even use the public safety system. You know what I'm saying? So if we have our own land, you know what I'm saying? And we always talk about sovereignty, and we always talk about going back and retrying all the Black Americans that's been under this motherfucking wicked government, under our own motherfucking judicial system. And man, we talk about this all the time. This is think conversations that we have. So just because you haven't been hearing the conversations, you know what I'm saying, because you haven't been tapped in, it's very disrespectful and very disingenuous to step in a room and make it seem like this is not the conversations and we're not all on the same page. You are better off coming in, you know what I'm saying, and asking and say, look, man, I've been talking about reparations since da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, you know what I'm saying? Everybody in here seems like they talk about reparations, so how can I bring the stuff that I've been talking about and the things that y'all have that we all want, and how can we tie it together so that I can represent y'all out in California? If you'd have did some shit like that, bro, you probably would have got some damn donations or shit, some shit tonight. But instead, you came in like we was just some damn fools or some idiots or somebody who hasn't been tapped in, who don't read or who don't write. I don't know who you dealing with or who you, but come on, bro. I said that. I just look like this. This shit for real. You know what I'm saying? And I'd have been through the system. I've been somebody who locked up that's in the streets. You know what I'm saying? Tapped in. So you ain't talking to nobody. When you start talking about talking my language, you know what I'm saying? I want to see what's going on. Because I know when niggas is just motherfucking gassing, and I know when folks is just telling war stories, because I've been around them niggas that just tell war stories all damn day. You know what I'm saying? I did 3 years of it, actually. You know what I'm saying? So, bro, it's, you know, and like they said, you will come in and you go for the people's champ, and you can't even not keep your composure, you know what I'm saying, and not be stuttering, you know what I'm saying, and shit like that. Nah, and this is just man, I'm not even trying to, you know what I'm saying, this is just real, real nigga shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, you got to go in there, bro, you know what I'm saying, man? SB man, bro, we was outnumbered when we was out in there talking to reparations when it came to Black and white folks. You know what I'm saying? What that mean? We had just followed behind a man who was talking about how he was broke and he ain't had no money and he ain't, what that mean? You know what I'm saying? But B man turned up and I came right back. We hit him with a two. You know what I'm saying? And that's how you got to be, because you're going to be around people who are going to be trying to pull all your cards. You know what I'm saying? And you got to be able to, if somebody knows that you're anti-whatever and they can't bring this up without you and stepping off your and not being able, man, you know how much they bring it, Marcel? You know how much they bring it, Tariq Nasheed? You know how many times they try to come up there to Jason Black and they try to just throw these, and every time it's sidestepped. And I mean, so smooth and so player, you know what I'm saying? And they come, if you can't beat them, come on, bro. You know what I'm saying? So that's why it's like, bro, you come tap in, you know what I'm saying? If you're really serious, you know what I'm saying? Come tap in, come be involved, you know what I'm saying? Come understand, come read, come really figure out, you know, and bro, you'll be all right, you know what I'm saying? You'll be all right, you know? I appreciate anybody that's really trying to go out there and do the work. But don't come and don't disrespect the people. Don't disrespect, you know what I'm saying, Marcel. You know, we don't rock like that. That shit's off code. And if you off code, you know what I'm saying? And like I told you in the other space, and like we done told Marcel, and like Marcel done said himself, and like I said about me, if y'all ever support me and I'm up there and I'm talking about some LGBT or some Black and Brown coalition, anything, bro, put one in my head, because they done cloned me. That's not Montana. That ain't me, bro. They done took me, they done cloned me, and they got somebody else up there speaking. Nah, take me out. You know what I'm saying? And that's how I feel. You know what I'm saying? Because with great responsibility, you know, great power come great responsibility. So if you getting supported, et cetera, and we done put it behind you, and you ain't standing on the 10, you know what I'm saying? Man, you already know how you gonna get treated. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, just... you know, respectfully, I'm gonna let everybody else rock. I gotta flip it. Their price.
Hold on one moment. Let me reset the room. Y'all, this is our. Hold up. I'm about to reset the room. This is our. This space was made to recap the space between Marcel and Dion talking about politics or talking about what they're going to do for our communities concerning reparations and politics of our interests. As y'all can see, it was a dispute over Marcel's, you know, whatever he do in his room or what have you. And that led us here. And I personally walked away hearing talks about Marcel's sexuality, whatever he do outside his room,
more than I've heard Marcel bring it up than any space or any engagement I heard him talking about. And that shouldn't have been what I walked away with. That shouldn't have been what none of us walked away with. We should have been walking away with a complete reparations pact. And what are you going to do for Foundation of Black Americans? What are you going to do for United States Freedmen concerning reparations, immigration, moratorium, and all of these things that are affecting our community? But we got something else, which is why we're here. All right. I have three other things to go over. If y'all haven't donated to Marcel's campaign, please do so. You can in the Jumbotron and go to his website. Also, there's two petitions in the Jumbotron, one concerning for us to get a black anti hate crime bill. Please sign a petition. And there's another one calling out NARC and a Cobra. Please sign that one too. It's very easy. All right, the one with NARC and a Cobra, you already know they're just all bad when it comes to our reparations. They get paid on the act, on the back end, grants from like organizations like the MacArthur Foundation, and they want to pass weak-ass HR 40 so they can get paid on the front end too and be in control of our reparations. They just all bad. We kicking them to the curb. All right. I appreciate y'all. We're going to go to the next person, and we're going to actually go to Claire.
Can I be heard?
Go ahead, yes, Ms.
I'm going to be very quick because I'm tired and I've been waiting a while. Dion, when you were speaking, a lot of things you said resonated, but I'm just going to pull out one. When you stated that you did not know about the reparation meetings that happened in California. And there was more than one meeting. And I have family in California. They're senior citizens. One of my aunts couldn't even make it to the meeting, but she knew about the meeting. Who has daily health challenges, and she knew about it. She was preparing to move. She knew about it. So how did you not know about it? Because when I called to speak to my family in California, I'm on the East Coast, by the way, they knew about it. So how is it you're running for some type of political platform and you don't know? You don't know. That is, to me personally, a disgrace. It's a disgrace. I am doing this for my family, for my ancestors, the ones that came before me. I have everyone in my family on my back, and it's an honor. Please don't misunderstand. I am my family's historian. So as I'm going down the line and gathering information, I'm enjoying it, but I know why I'm doing it. It's not for me. It's for everyone that came before me. For every elder in my family that's still alive, I'm doing it for them. And how is it that someone that says they're representing all of these people doesn't know anything? And as a brother said in the other space, to judge a person on the content of their character. I don't know you very well. I wish only the best for you. With a little bit of character that you've shown, it's not good. It's not someone that I would trust. It's not someone that I would say, okay, we're in this together and understand why we're doing what we're doing. And I just can't accept any reason that you could come up with for not knowing about what's happening in the state that you're in, that you're supposed to be representing. And I know. And I'll land there. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Clarice. Definitely want to hear some new voices. So welcome, Justeve, Elevation, Cadillac, and Promote. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Go ahead, Justeve, and then Elevation, and then Cadillac.
Black first to the room. Is Dion going to respond to Ms. Claire's question? I mean, I thought that was a good question.
And please, you all, hold up. Before you go, Dion, everybody, please retweet out the space. We want our family to be able to hear this, so please retweet out the space. And if you haven't already, follow me and the rest of the co-hosts, and, of course, Cherie and Black Voltron, the MVP. Go ahead, Dion.
Yeah, so I said that I didn't know. I know about AB3121. I actually spoke with a gentleman. I interviewed a gentleman named Chris Dotson or something, his last name. I have him on my YouTube channel. I interviewed him about a couple of years ago before he was, I think he was on the task force, if I'm not mistaken. Don't quote me on that, all right? But I think he had something to do with the task force.
Yeah, so I just muted because I don't want to hear the answer to that question, because you're clearly not on a reparations platform, because you didn't show up to none of AB3121. I showed up at every fucking one, and I'm in Georgia. So you're not on a reparations platform, clearly. So we just gonna, you know, let's go on, because there's no excuse as to why you did not make a public comment. You could go on oag.ga/AB3121 and pull up every recording. You could pull up the schedule. You could pull up the meeting notes. You can pull up the slides. You could pull up everything. So for you not to know the phone number to call, nobody, like, you didn't care. You didn't care about reparations, because if you did, you would have been at the church, right? It was free parking, I heard, there too. That's obviously something major in California, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? But you're not on a reparations platform, okay? So let's just stop saying that. I know it sounds good. I know it's the hot ticket right now. You know what I'm talking about? You know, a whole bunch of people talking about reparations out of the blue, but ain't been nowhere. And for you to be in California and not, oh, I know about it. Chris is not a part of the task force. The chairwoman of the task force is running, though, right? So I don't know if you're the first reparations candidate. I heard you say something like that, and I'm still confused as to how you're not actively involved with Newsom or any of that, if you're in politics of any level, any capacity for, you know, since Hip Hop for President. I'm just confused. So let's just move on, because you are clearly not on a reparations platform, because you did not show up in the first state that literally passed the law for it, sir. No. There's nothing you could say. Nothing.
Well, Black First, April. Absolutely. You always know how to word it.
Am I going to be able to respond, or No, brother.
This was the thing that I had a problem in the other room. Look, I'm going to let the people speak. These are the people that could potentially vote for you. All right. Do you see the problem here? I'm going to let you know the problem here. The problem here is that you in California, and me and my brothers and sisters all the way across the other side of the country, but we know more about what's going on in your own state and what's going on in the concerns of your people, the people that you're supposed to represent. We know what plagues them more than you, and we're actively in this, and we're doing this, and we're all the way across the country and around the country and nowhere around you. This is a place for you now to be able to listen, gather the information, to hopefully take this constructive criticism and do something with it. And that's not for us to do. That's for you to do for you. What we gonna do is keep maintaining our stability as the grassroots and make sure that we keep on out here stomping the ground and advocating for our people. So when people like you come around and you say that you're for reparations and you use reparations as a buzzword, like that Arizona pledge pack, and we're not playing with them either. We're not playing with nobody across the entire country. Reparations is not a buzzword. It's a lifestyle. It's something you do. It's something that you actively advocate for.
And when you're not in these spaces, and when you're not in, and you're not in a room
in the meeting at Oakland, it was just a meeting in Oakland.
If you're not in a, if you're not in a room with Oakland, and you're not in a, and you're not a room with AB 3121, and you're not going to give public speaking or nothing, you're not doing nothing to speak to the public about these at these events, which would be great promotion for you as a candidate. Easy promotion, easy. And you talking about you a reparations candidate? I beg to differ. This right here, this is a place for our people to speak so you can hear the, from the grassroots, all right? Who got next?
Hey, real quick, and I just want to say, because shout out.
Y'all in this mute.
I didn't hear that time, but you know I'm ready for it. If y'all, yeah, but like, shout out to Max, you know what I'm saying? Because Max was up there. You know what I'm saying? And Max came in and he had spoke and he had said something about the number in California. And we was like, you know what I'm saying? Hey, my dog, hey, this federal, you know what I'm saying? 151 million. And he was like, please send me the information so that I can blah, blah, blah. He ain't one time take no offense or make it feel like we was, no, bro. Nah, it's not nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? It's, look, let's all get on one page and one accord so we can take a uniform message. And if the information has already been done, tap into everybody so we can get the resources. And I'm going to start right there. Go ahead, just Eve.
Thank you very politely. And no offense, Dion, like the brothers have been saying, you know, this is the time to sit back and try to soak it all in so that if you really are about this, then you can get, you know, get it started. Authenticity. If you listen to the new black media, then you would know how to be authentic or what it is to be authentic. And honestly, you know, like Montana said, he definitely took the words right out of my mouth. Nobody has a problem with the nuclear family, especially for us. And Marcel has said as much. So I think that maybe because you know how we feel about that, you know, our conservative views, you know, you might have thought that it was a way to get in. But if you had been in the soil, you would know. And I'm going to land there.
B1, sister.
Thank you, sister. Thank you. Thank you, sister. Go ahead, Elevation and Cadillac.
Peace. Number one, I'm glad the brother said that he's against homosexuality. Two, I'm glad he said he will not be buck broken. And three, the brother has a lot of room for growth, like we all do. And it will be a good idea, just like Just Eve says, for him to be more familiarized with the new black media so he can be better prepared when he goes out there and speaks on a reparation platform, if that's really what he wants to do. Peace.
That was dope. I appreciate that, Elevation, a lot, because that's what I was kind of, I wanted to, you know, like, you know, we giving it to you, you know, respectfully, you know what I'm saying? Pause. But, you know, we still fucking with you, right? Like, you know, we really want you to get it, right? I do feel that way. I agree. You know, just take some notes. We got a long way to go. But go ahead, Cadillac.
Please let me jump in there. Please.
Yeah, I just want to say, I don't mean we gonna vote for you this time.
No, I never said that.
Yeah, but, I know. I'm just...
You gotta hold on, Cherie. We got way too many hands and people.
No, let Cherie. Let Cherie go.
Yo, I'm just saying that, like, the thing that pisses me the fuck off and that I know pisses my foundational Black American. American descendants of chattel slavery, freedmen, people off, is that these people think they can gum up and just say a special trigger word and we're supposed to jump in and be like, oh no, I support you. Who the fuck are you? You have to prove yourself to us. I don't know you, nigga. I don't know you. What I know is that I want liberation for my people. What I know is that I'm 10 toes, motherfucking 20 toes down for fucking reparations, not just reparations in that fucking, oh, we gonna throw reparations out there and anything that falls under that. No, reparations, policies, protections, and payments for my fucking people. And what I have fucking learned, brother Dion, from being in a space with you and giving
so much time for you to give your perspective over and over again is that you are not for the people. You are not for the collective. And I want you, I'm again, just drive this shit home, brother, because again, I don't know you. I don't know you. I don't know you. I don't give a fuck about you as a person. That does not resonate on my fucking list of what am I going to deal with today, Sharita. You see, it, you don't fucking register, my nigga. Not at all. But if you step up on the stage and you say you are for reparations, nigga, you, I want you to understand you have put out a bat signal. My nigga, this is not 1969. This is 2022, nigga. When you say reparations, you put that bat signal out. Niggas finna show the fuck up. They're gonna question you. They're gonna hold you to that standard. Do you understand? Okay, we're here. No, no. There's no just putting that word out there and just stepping back and that's it. Not at all. So I just wanted to just really drive home. Please, please, because I'm not in California. I'm not in fucking South Carolina. But I damn sure did my motherfucking part with elevating Marcel up to the national stage, my nigga. And that's what I want to impress upon you. You do not, if you really think that all you have to do is hone in on just Black Americans in California, you fucking lose. You fucking lose because there are so many of us across the fucking country. Across the country that are waiting for one of us to step the fuck up and show out for us and our people. And if you're willing to do that, we're going to support you, my nigga, from the continental USA to the fucking outliers. Goddamn motherfucking Hawaii, nigga. People going to be sending you goddamn donations. You got to be ready to show up and prove that you are here for us. And what I saw tonight is that you are not here for us. You are here for your fucking anti-gay agenda. I don't give a fuck about gay people. I care about Black American people, nigga. And you need to get on that same page. Damn, when you do, you're going to have so much fucking support. Nigga, why don't you understand that? We are fucking waiting. We are waiting and fucking pulsating. Oh my God, we like double dutch, nigga. We right here on the side, bitch. What? You for us, we in that bitch. We double dutching, we backflipping, all that shit. We ready. Okay. Stand up for us and fucking follow the fuck through. All right? That's all I want to motherfucking say.
Thank you, sweetheart. Damn. Thank you. We appreciate you. 5'3". Yes, I said
5'6". April, don't look, nigga.
Go ahead, Cadillac.
Hey, I had a chance to speak in the earlier space. I just want to say this, brother. We don't have an LGBT agenda. We don't have a LGBT not out here killing us in the streets and doing all this crazy shit, right? White supremacists is, right? Gone are the days where we just give our votes to a person because they Black or they speak this language that they feel like we want to hear, right? Today, it's some whole new shit popping, bro. And if you want to get on that platform, I just sent Marcel some money not even 25 minutes ago. You see what I'm saying? Because I know he's speaking for Black First. Foundational Black Americans getting what we need, bro. All this fucking people of color, all this minority shit, all this diaspora shit, and all this kumbaya shit with all Black people, all people of color, we not with none of that shit no more. You see what I'm saying? This the grassroots, bro. If you want to build your platform up, bro, I told you to reach out to the brother and connect with the brother and learn what he doing. Learn what you need to learn, bro. Sit in these spaces and listen, bro. Get you a fucking burner account and just sit in these B1 spaces and listen, bro. If you want that if you want that support, same support that Marcel built from the ground up, you're going to have to do the same thing, bro, or you're not going to get an office, bro. You've been running for some years. You ain't got an office, bro. It's because you're not listening. You think we give a fuck about LGBT, nigga? LGBT ain't fucking with me out here. I'm not LGBT. I don't give a fuck about that. You see what I'm saying? I give a fuck about my children. I got 5 sons, nigga. And these niggas here, the police is on their ass, nigga. Every chance they get, nigga. They got billions of dollars per year that's going to these fucking organizations that's out here to take their ass down, put their ass in jail, kill them or whatever. You see what I'm saying? It ain't the LGBT who doing it. So you on this bullshit LGBT shit, we don't give a fuck about that. I land my plane.
Thanks for your input, brother. We gonna go to Pro because I know he been there for a long time. Then we gonna go to Well.
Appreciate it, brother. Also, I wanted to say to you in particular, man, I heard you in a few spaces before, man, and you brought a tear to my eye bringing that energy on what we really about. But I also want to shout out to The Room, April, Montana, Black Voltron, of course, my sister, Cherie. How you doing, girl? B-Man, everybody in the room. So, like the Black majority said earlier, man, you got a lot of things misconstrued when it comes to the difference between Black homosexual, LGBT, and white LGBT. And when you kept on saying that you can't be on code, I'm sitting here looking at my wife like, has this dude never heard of James Baldwin? Like, bro, there's already been a historical precedent of somebody who was on code despite their personal lifestyle. So that's why everybody was telling you are off code because you ain't even got your history. And then you're condescending because you don't understand. We already vetted that man. Hell, that man followed me back before he even blew up, dude. I was like, man, look at this dude. He running for reparations before he even had a blue check by his name or anything I knew about that man. So for me, I'm here to tell you, man, you need to put your ego to the side and stop being jealous. Because what it sounds like to me is you've been running for some years and ain't had the same traction. And this brother came out of nowhere and you noticed it and now you're feeling away. Well, you wouldn't have to feel away if you was tapped in. So that's where it goes back to. We don't trust mainstream media. So because we don't trust mainstream media, when you talk about Tariq and Jason, and I heard how condescending you said that, like, oh, I haven't been on Tariq, I haven't been on Jason, like it was funny. We take this shit seriously. That was not funny. We be on there because them brothers are speaking truth to power. So speaking of truth to power, I was very insulted to hear you even bring up Powernomics, bro, because Powernomics changed my life. That's the reason why I'm on my own land right now. So when you talk about Powernomics, you got to come correct. You say you was running for president talking about you don't need someone's vote. If you're trying to run for president, don't you need everybody's vote? I mean, come on now. We understand that if you're going to run for president, that has departments, that has advisors, that has counselors. Like, you're not just doing this alone, so you're talking about who you don't need, bro. That's extremely off code. If you really talking about you going to run for president, hell, I even daydream about running for president, bro. I'm already on some. You got to build jobs. What you doing for the people? Who are you increasing in your circle? So you just coming out here trying to condescend on us, bro. Nobody's having it. And that's why I shout out to The Room and the host for shutting you down appropriately, bro. We not playing no games out here. We living this shit. That's, yeah, if I was you and somebody's coming at me like, oh, what you going to do? How we know you really about it? Bro, I'm out here on my land. I know what I'm going to do with my money. I know what I'm going to do for my people. I know what I'm trying to build, houses, power, water. I know what I'm doing. So what are you doing? So you just talking, bro. We pass people just talking. So go back and do your homework. Go back and read the book again from back to front. Hell, Dr. Cloud was even talking about using the old dead church. He been talking about reusing stuff. And you over here talking about what you don't need, talking about you want to be president. But get your act together, man. And I'll just land my plane there. Shout out to y'all. B1 family. Wealth Warren Reparations. Let's go.
B1, brother. Thank you. And thank you for that compliment. Yes. Dion, bro, this a new day. We learn from our ancestors' successes as well as their mistakes, and we are not going to make those mistakes again because we know our ancestors' history. And if you fail to learn your history, you are going to repeat those same mistakes, and we're destined to not do that because look at us. Look at us. Look at the grassroots. Look how politically engaged we are, all right? We're politically astute, all right? We reading books. We're learning. We know who we are, all right? This is what you call, this is guerrilla politics in action, something we've been talking about, all right? So if you're not going to represent us possibly, what we going to do? We're going to go look in the mirror, and we're going to be our own politicians. We're going to represent our people properly, all right? We're controlling the narrative now. You telling us that you're not on social media like that, but damn near every politician in the country using Twitter as a political apparatus. That's another thing that you're doing wrong. Because look at us. We're controlling the narrative. All right. Go ahead. Well, hell yeah. And we're going to keep it going.
Hey, family. Dion, I'm going to try and... like you had wanted, you know, how you were going to, reset the tone. Would you like to apologize to us before I just, you know, have a, you know, a monologue because, you know, you're not coming back with any conversation, which is fine. But would you like to apologize to us so we can start off fresh?
Well, we asked him to listen, so.
But I'm asking, would he like to apologize, Dion?
He can speak if he wants. Go ahead.
Yeah. Would you like to apologize, Dion?
Great question, Wahoya. Great question. Thank you.
If there are any misconstrued, I've been listening for quite some time.
That most would be a no. Okay, thank you.
Well, let's not interrupt him. We're not. That's not what we're gonna do. I don't know. This ain't none of that. So let's relax. You know what I'm saying? Because he was speaking. So we'll allow him to speak since you asked him to apologize. You know what I'm saying? Let him actually open his mouth. Thank you.
Respectfully, co-host. I've been trying to deal with a very bad tooth problem right now. So I'm trying to give as much as I'm getting from him. So respectfully, all he had to say was yes or no. But I'm not feeling very well right now. And I live in California, so I really wanted to speak to him. So if that's okay, I would think a yes or no for him would have sufficed. I don't know about the room, but I think that would have done it. I don't know. But if I may I continue?
I'm not looking for an apology. I'm really not. But yeah, can you please get to your point?
I shall try. Dion, I know that you're wanting to convey to us that, you know, you're amongst us by, you know, making a reference to the people that were asking questions, my brother, my sister. See, that's condescending to me as one of your potential constituents, because I wouldn't take that if it was just a normal conversation with nothing very valid and something that is dear to my heart was even up for grabs. It's like it's a very flippant type of tone that you have. Marcel, whether he's gay or not, all of us in the Black community, we've always had a person, different situations all through our family. So even if we did have a gay cousin, but that gay cousin worked in the military and he kicked ass, if my aunt or my sister or my cousin, they were gay, but they did something that was valid, that doesn't negate them because they like something of the same sex. So when you throw that out there before saying to us, but I'm not going to do it because, I mean, you can vote for him if you want to. Well, you know, I don't live in his area. Most of these people don't live here in this area. I'm talking to you with a fucked up jaw because I want you to know, look, brother, we need you. All we're saying is just fucking peep the room. If you are a down ass motherfucker like the rest of us, when you out there on a daily, you know, driving around these, alcohol stores, first of all, why don't you try to get rid of them? We don't need that shit in our community. We don't need fucking alcohol stores. So, you know, just message on the side. But the other thing is when I sort of feel like this and, you know, I've been busted on it myself. When you say some shit in front of other people, then you get around somebody else, but you can't get out your shit because you came in like, I don't give a fuck what they say to me. I'm a stand what I stand on and I'm not backing down. That's why you seem so abrasive. We were trying to tell you, wait, you know, partner, slow down. What are you talking about? And you just seemed as if you just weren't going to have it because you had already made a promise to somebody else that you weren't going to back down. And we need to have people with Marcel. We need to break into this bullshit arena. And if you really, really thought about it, Dion, your ancestors, I mean, come on. You missed a fucking meeting and that's all you had to do? You don't have a Siri? You don't have an Alexa? You ain't got one of them old time ticklers to say, it's an important meeting today. That's why you got up today. That's what you're backing it on. So it seems so disingenuous when you say, you know, you've been doing this. I mean, you know, and I think, you know, Brother Harriet was right. I mean, and please, come on. I'm going to say this and I'm going to shut the hell up. The words that you pick, like, you're not going to buck break me. Everybody in this fucking that's listening, we know that because we play the dozens with each other. That's a real sensitive fucking word. You know the brother's gay, but you're gonna say you ain't gonna butt break me. You ain't gotta come that fucking raw. Maybe you didn't mean it or whatever, but I'm one of them niggas that I'll catch some shit like that. You can't be saying shit like that when you ain't around all your brothers and sisters. You get up there with them crackers, they just need one little word, and they think, oh, we got us a coon.
We're not trying to come at you. We're not trying to come at you, but I'm telling you right motherfucking now, I live in California, and I'm going to peep some shit. All we're trying to tell you is calm your nutsack. And please, I like dick. I don't know why you so upset about Marcel liking dick. It was some good dick. I like dick. All I'm saying is just get off his nutsack, because shit is looking kind of creepy. I mean, he's you know, whatever. Fuck. I don't even care. Like I said, my motherfucking mouth hurt. I ain't even trying to do all of this. But the last thing I am going to tell you, please, baby, whether somebody is 30 seconds or 30 minutes late from you talking and you act as if it's insulting to you, you was motherfucking 30 whatever late to a meeting that you didn't go to, that you were supposed to be there for us. I mean, seriously, go get some ass or something, or some yak, a cold drink or something, but recheck your shit. Because you know niggas like us don't ride that motherfucking way. But calm your mucky ass down. I love y'all. My tooth hurt. Fuck!
This motherfucker.
Yo, all right. Go ahead, man.
Kia.
Yeah, go ahead, Keith.
What a piece of the tribe. You know how the family do. Good to see everybody. I want to say a couple of things. First of all, early I popped in the group and I was hearing some disparaging things that you were saying about Brother Marcel, which, to be honest, doesn't mean nothing. You know what I mean? He's B1. He's black first. He's putting everything on the line, and he got the support of so many different people from all over the country. I want to point out, there's a lot of, I live out here in the Bay Area. I'm right here in Richmond. I was just in Vallejo yesterday, right there on Tennessee, picking up some stuff straight from the little smoke shop. You know what I mean? I'm out here in the Bay. So what Brother Black Boltron was saying to you earlier was some real shit, and I felt him, because if you out here, I ain't never heard of you. No one on this whole app has ever heard of you. So if you really out here doing this reparation thing, somebody should have heard of you. Now, I ain't trying to disparage you, get you to stop running and all that stuff, but when you coming in these spaces, I'm going to tell you straight up, most people is militant enough to recognize that that's some op shit. This man is about to go for, they about to vote either against him or for him. And a week before, or 2 weeks or whatever before Marcel's, they got a vote, you jump into these rooms and you start saying disparaging things. And then you go and say, oh, well, you can vote for me or you can vote for Marcel. We're not running against each other. If y'all ain't running against each other, there's no reason for you to say anything negative or disparaging about him. That's really the code. Being on code is so important. That teaches, like, people will peep little shit and be like, oh, you off code. I ain't fucking with you, period. Like, for you to be a reparationist candidate, I would love to vote for you. But if you off code, that vote is a no off top. Because I don't care. I wouldn't even trust a person who's off code to speak for me at all. Like, I'll just wait for the next nigga. You get what I'm saying? There will be more niggas. You see how many people in these groups right now? You see how many people in California right now? Yes, there's going to be about 3-5 candidates, reparation candidates this next run. Best to believe, 10 the following year, 30 the following year. We running this bitch. This shit is over. You get what I'm saying? Reparations is coming. It just depends on if you on code or not. So I just really hope, for real, that you put all that homophobic bullshit to the side, and I'm straight as an arrow, but that shit ain't got nothing to do with getting our reparations. It's about being black first, man. Come on, man. So, like, all that talking about the nigga because he's gay, who gives a damn? He don't even talk about that shit. You feel me? So it's just like, there got to be an on-code type of situation. Maybe you need to jump into these groups, you know what I mean, and start figuring out how to be on code. And another thing is, you're not even verified. Marcel is verified on the back. He's straight. We know who he is. He's verified. We don't know you. You get what I'm saying? We know each other's lineages around here. We know we FBA. I don't know if you Jamaican or half African. I don't know who you are. And you right here in Vallejo, nigga, that's right across the bridge from me, my nigga. So come on, man. Let's get on it. I land my plane. Blessing to the family.
Thank you, my good, you know, verified brother. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm saying?
Or Fraction Black. Shout out to Check. All right, go ahead.
Shout out to my verified family out here, because we out here, okay? Niggas love to verify who the fuck they are. Shout out to my verified family.
Yeah, definitely shout out to that. So I wanted to say real quick, and then B-Man and Black Voltron for sure. So, you know, I guess, so if the platform is reparations, I was so confused as to how that became such a topic, right? Like, even if it did come up, like, why you didn't swing it back on around to reparations? So, yeah, I'm still concerned. I'm still kind of baffled as to how you're in California and I've never heard of you when it comes to rallying, lobbying for reparations. You know, you should have been out in the street letting Black Americans know that they had an inheritance. Like, it's literally happening. You know about AB 3121. And so I just, you know, I that doesn't sit with me at all. Go ahead, B-Man, and then Voltron.
All right, a couple things. I'll try to keep this quick here. The reason why I'd asked you about your website was for a couple reasons. One, you were saying that the domains, both of them ended with something, something for president, but you're running for something in Congress right now. So at bare minimum, man, just as just for orderly type things, you'd want to clean up your damn domain and have that shit mimicking what it is, not the thing from what you had from 2016 or whatever, bro. That's just lazy. Then I went to the damn website. It was while I was here waiting. I was booted off or whatever, but I'm and I was here waiting, and I'm on the Deion D. Jenkins for president, and then I got another blog or some shit, bro. This website, bro, we got standards here and expectations, bro. For as Black men, dog, we talking about Black excellence, bro. The website is pathetic as fuck. And so I tweeted out to somebody and I said, you needed to holler at Uncle Luke or Luther. You ain't even calling him Uncle. Nigga, because your fucking website is selling your music CD. He can get you on game with that, bro. It's like this, man. You heard everybody in here talking about this. Cadillac Black, he mentioned, you know, the police murdering us with impunity. We're sitting here beating this drum heavy for reparations, and our survival depends on it, bro. It depends on it. It ain't a game, and it ain't no damn joke. So if you want to do this shit, bro, you're going to have to come correct with that shit. And it just ain't, I mean, this ain't cutting it. Because each time when somebody called you out on something, you'd always try to deflect it back to saying that they weren't in there from the beginning either, bro. That just ain't it, bro. These are people that have really been putting in this work day in and day out. We eat this. We live this and we breathe this, bro.
We gonna go to Black Voltron. And then I'm gonna let Deion speak, and then I want everybody to get a closing they closing statements, and then we gonna close this out.
Appreciate it, Harry Tubmans. Guess who's back, Deion? It's me, again from the town. Your boy from the town, and I'm gonna come at you differently. Apparently, you misunderstood my anger at you, thinking it was some personal shit, some jealous shit, some whatever shit. That is completely, get that out your mind right now. It had nothing to do with that. Nothing. Nothing. The reason why I was pissed off is because you are the first you were supposed to be the first reparationist candidate from California. Okay? That means you are on the vanguard. You're the pioneer. You are supposed to be representing us. You are running for United States Senate. That is a prestigious position throughout planet Earth, all right? And you're supposed to be representing foundational Black Americans and our reparations push to this wicked white supremacist United States of America. And what did you do? You fucked it up. your just B-Man stole some of my thunder, but and you know, appreciate you, B-Man, love you, but I'm just pissed, man, that you were supposed to come as a reparations candidate, meaning you were supposed to be prepared. You are in Vallejo. I don't know if you were born and raised there, but I'm third generation, fourth generation actually, Oakland, California, born and raised. Okay, I'm from the town, partner, and you are supposed to represent us from the Bay, and you came with some slapstick niggotry, yelling, hollering, and screaming at Marcel Dixon, who's all the way across the country in South Carolina. Okay, I've been to South Carolina. Okay, been to Charleston. I know that area well. All right, and the only thing you kept talking about is LGBT, a little on your reparations plan. But like B-Man says, you go to your website, nigga, you selling some bunk ass album. Nigga, fuck your tape. If you want to be a goddamn entertainer, go with 40, go with Short, you know, go with the folks up there in the V and be an entertainer. You know, get on down into Hollywood and stuff like that, or make your album and stuff like that. Don't come as an entertainer, then try to say you're a presidential candidate, then say now you're running for Senate, United States Senate. You're supposed to be going up against Alex Padilla. You're supposed to be going up against Dianne Feinstein and the 30 other goddamn California senators. And you embarrassed us as a representative from the Bay, dude. You made the Bay look sad, trifling, disgustingly weak and disorganized. You're supposed to be a professional, and you look like shit. You look trifling. You ain't ready. You don't have your website together. It's Marcel has Marcel Dixon for Senate. You talking about running for president from fucking 4 years ago, 6 years ago? Come on, man. You're supposed to represent us. You're supposed to be my representative, and you come with this bullshit like this goddamn Three Stooges? Nigga, this ain't Comedy Hour, Amateur Hour. You were running for United States Senate. You ain't even been to no reparations meetings. I'm down here in Oakland. I'm an hour and 15 minutes, hour and a half away from Sacramento. That means you are 45 minutes away to an hour if you drive slow as fuck up 80. You stop with the bullshit. You are unprepared. And the most pressing thing for Foundation of Black Americans right now is reparations. But for us specifically in California, we desperately need these reparations from 3121. We are being gentrified the fuck out of California, not just the Bay, not from Northern California, not from Southern California, from the Bay. You seeing all the homeless people up there in Vallejo, down here in Oakland? There's no excuse as a reparations candidate for you not to be at every single fucking meet. I don't give a fuck if it's from San Diego all the way up to goddamn Crescent City. You're supposed to be there. That's your job as a representative, a candidate running for United States Senate. How can I take you seriously as a candidate when you ain't even did your goddamn homework? Oh, I didn't know it was a goddamn meeting. Nigga, please. That is unacceptable. And you supposed to be my senator? I'm supposed to vote for you? Get the fuck out of here, dude. Partner, everything you do is representative of you. This space was your introduction to all of us, and you failed it. You don't get a second chance to make a first impression. You failed at that. You failed in your job interview, because this was your job interview as a candidate for United States Senator, and you failed it. You came unprepared. You weren't ready. So I have to move on to the next candidate who's supposed to be ready. You filed your for California, the date to file your paperwork is February 9th, 2022. Where the hell were you? How come you weren't in any of these spaces? You just to file, but you thought about this last year in 2021. You could have been raising money, getting the word out, just like Marcel was doing. All right. He was doing this in September. You could, if you were a serious political candidate, you would have been doing this back in 2020. You would have been in these new black media spaces. You would have told us everything that's about you. You would have had a website, several websites. Dion D. Jenkins for United States Senate, the reparationist candidate. You'd be at every single black empowerment meeting. You would have been at every single black empowerment Twitter space. You'd been all throughout the new black media, up and down, up and down. And you complaining about Tariq, Jason Black, Professor Black Truth, and all the rest of the New Black Media people didn't respond to you, guess what? They didn't do that to Marcel either. He kept emailing. He kept pestering them. He kept bothering them. He kept jumping into space. He jumped on Twitter. He put in the work, brother. Your work ethic sucks. And you are embarrassment to us in the Bay. That's why I'm pissed off. I was expecting the best Black excellence from you, Dion, and you fucked it up. You about that nigger tree, the bullshit, the plantation antics, gay this, gay that, gay this. You not once talked about the fucking immigration that's getting us the fuck out of here. They bringing the goddamn Asians up here, the Hispanics, the Ukrainians, the Afghans down there in Fremont. You knew, you supposed to know all about that. You did not mention that once in that space last time. Where the fuck are you, dude? Do you not see the Black people who are getting pushed out of here, gentrified? You talked about the people going to Manteca, Lathrop, Sacramento, Stockton, goddamn Yuba City, Fresno, Los Banos, Texas, Louisiana, goddamn South Carolina. We're getting pushed out everywhere. Not once did you mention that shit. And you wondering why I'm pissed off at you? You better than that, nigga. You're running for United States Senate. You're supposed to be the best of the best. How the hell are you going to go up against Alex Padilla and Dianne Feinstein and all the rest of these white supremacists out here? These white Hispanics. And you can't even do the goddamn basics. Get the word out. Push, 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 push. Didn't nobody say this was supposed to be easy? You chose this. You, Deion D. Jenkins, you chose to do this. And you came out half-assed, half-cocked, and trifling, and you're making us look goddamn silly. You already know that our grandparents taught us to be 5 to 10 times better than these white folks, and you going for something this high profile, and you came with some Mickey Mouse ratchet shit? No, brother. You don't get a second chance to make a first impression, and you've lost that opportunity. I land on that. Be one to the fullest.
B1, brother, go ahead and respond to Dion. Then we all going to give our last statements. And we're going to give our final statements, ending actually with Black Voltron. And then we're going to close this out, you guys.
Yes, sir. Thanks for letting me speak. I don't know. I'm getting a lot of notifications on my Twitter, people retweeting my post saying that they stand on my side, that they're going to vote. I'm getting just about damn near every minute. I'm getting a new Twitter follower. So I don't know about that. I think the people, you know, who understand my stance, they're going to support me, and I'm confident with that. Now to respond,
that was me, family. I ain't gonna, bro. Just, bro, go ahead, bro. Say what you got to say, because you're starting to really piss me off at this point, for real, for real.
Yeah, so I just wanted to respond based on what he was saying. You know, I am in the streets. I'm trying to let as many people as I possibly can know about my campaign. I'm only one person. I did have a team. But, you know, my funds is only going so far. So I'm doing the best that I can do to spread the word. And, you know, if I can't please everybody, the only thing that I can do is stand on my principles of who I am as a candidate. And I think the real issue, you know, like, you're absolutely right. We have to represent, but to look at my website and judge it because I'm a grassroots hip hop organizer and because I'm using what I do as a hip hop artist. I mean, we live in an era where we have a Black genocide campaign in hip hop music and rap music. So I started off as a hip hop artist at first before I ever got into politics. I transformed that into a parallel position in politics using hip hop. It's conscious hip hop. And I'm using my platform, my hip hop platform, as a way to spread a positive message in hip hop.
And you thought you could rap your way into office?
No. I never thought I could rap my way into office, but I do know that I can use a message in rap right? It takes more than rap to get into office. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I've done. Now, I've been criticized for that, and I've been praised for that. You know, I'm not an entertainer. I make that clear, that I'm not a rapper, a just a entertaining rapper. I'm not a Kanye West or none of that. I'm a Black grassroots hip-hop organizer. And the reason why I make that distinction is because of that, because rap do have a bad name. Commercial rap have killed any decency in that image, right? And we all understand that. So what I've done is I try to counter that with positivity. I'm not perfect. And like, you know, I've heard a lot of you talk, and believe me, I'm going to get better. And I've learned a lot from a lot of you guys. There are some things that I'm not compromising on, but I am going to compromise. I should have been at that meeting. I agree. And in the last space, I came correct about that. I said, yes, you are right. I didn't know, because I'm so intuned in the streets, and then I work and I'm trying to balance everything. And now I'm not really in tune with like stuff like that. And I should have been in tuned, and I try to be the best I can. Right. And I can be better, and I'm always willing to be better, you know. And at the end of the day, like I said, I'm going against Alex Padilla. There's nobody on that ballot right now talking about reparations and making it and bold enough to stand against white supremacy for a Black agenda. And that is something that we have to consider.
Real quick, I just got a question I want to make sure I ask. Sure. There you go. Sure. Are you for lineage-based reparations only?
Or of course. Okay. Yes, of course. Yeah. That's why I came up with the term for Blacks who descended from American slaves. That's a specific lineage group. That's what's owed to us. I've been talking about this since 2015, you know. I'm sorry that a lot of us haven't heard of me, and I should have did better. I agree. I should have done better in making sure that you guys heard of me. Like one lady said, I should have been popular by now. You're right. And I think that I failed with that part. But, you know, I can get better, right? And to respond based on, I'm not blaming Tariq Nasheed or Jason Black or anything. I don't know how that came out. Why would anybody think that I'm blaming them? Actually, Tariq seemed kind of supportive. He said, hey, man, hit me up, you know, in his Twitter space. So he didn't seem like a type of person who's not supportive. Jason Black, I haven't talked to him yet. I appeared on one of his podcasts and I called in, but we didn't really have an intense conversation yet to make a decision of whether or not he's kind of supportive or not. We haven't gotten there. All I've said is that somebody made a statement that why they haven't seen me on these stations, on these channels, and I can't control that. I can't control that. If a person puts me on their platform or in their podcast, that's out of my control. I can only control what I can do. But nah, I've heard you guys, and I'm willing to get better.
Hey, real quick, respectfully, because I did want to say something about that. No, you can. If you tap into the grassroots, look, man, if you do the hashtag Debate Marcel, it started April 11th, you know what I'm saying, of this year, you know, and we was actually in there, and these folks was dodging Marcel. They didn't want to debate Marcel. You know what I'm saying? Clyburn didn't want to debate Marcel, all these folks. And everybody in the room, shout out to the grassroots and the family, started reposting and atting these folks and set up a debate the next day, April 12th, where Marcel smoked on the Griot writer, and his platform started, it it gained so much notoriety and shit just started going and going. Man, that shit had like 30,000 views in like 24 hours or some shit like that. You know what I'm saying? That's how you connect, but you got to be tapped into the grassroots for that. You know what I'm saying? The people got to support you for that. You know what I'm saying? The people support it. We was all sitting there watching Marcel smoke on, man, I'm talking about, I had my popcorn and shit. It was like, it was a world premiere. Everybody in the grassroots knew about it, but you wasn't there. And you should have been there. So this is what we're talking about. You got to be tapped in. If you go, say you represent the people and you for the people, you got to be tapped in with the people on all aspects, or at least have somebody that's tapped in. If you're like, okay, I'm not tech savvy, cool, I'm be in the streets, but I'm definitely going to have somebody tapped in that knows the conversation and knows the things that's going on, that's making sure that I'm informed. Therefore, if anything that's important, I can make sure that I'm representing it. You know what I'm saying? I got a burner account, whatever the case you got to do. But we can't take no excuses from you. You know what I'm saying? You got to be on point. You got to be, if you want our vote, if you want to represent me, you know what I'm saying? If you want to represent Montana, you got to be on point, family. I got to feel like you got to do some shit I can't do. And right now, it don't seem like you're doing anything that I couldn't do out on my own. You know what I'm saying? I ain't 35 yet, though, so I can't run for president. You know what I'm saying? So, man, you got to go crazy.
All right, Dion, go ahead and give your closing statement, and then I'm going to go to my brothers and sisters, and they're going to get a closing statement, and I'm going to close this out.
Yes, and I agree with that. I think that I do need to start being more in tune with you guys. You know, you guys are, you know, the lineage that I'm trying to represent, so I've heard you. The only thing I'm not willing to compromise on is I'm really steadfast on taking away the protections from the LGBT community, and that's something I'm standing on. And but I'm a reparations first candidate, and I'm on the ballot. So if anybody, you know, want to vote, you can. If not, hey, it is what it is. But thanks for having me.
Go ahead, Sheree.
Nigga.
I already know what you're gonna say.
No, bro. Dion, listen, I want you to understand that we as a collective, okay, we want to have so many fucking candidates that are championing for our cause. That's what we want. We do not want to be sitting up here trying to chip away at what you're saying and say, fuck you, no, you're not what we want. Nah, get out of here, nigga. That's not what we want. We're literally grasping at fucking straws trying to keep you in the fucking game, dog. God damn. Damn. Like motherfucking Florida Evans, nigga. Damn. Whew. What I want you to understand is that foundational Black Americans, we're not that complicated. We're not. What you need to do is say what you mean what you say and bring that shit to fruition. What Marcel did is that he did not step out saying he wanted to be a politician. That's not how he even got into this motherfucking game. Was saying he wanted to be a politician is that he had these certain ideals and he wanted to impress them upon the world. That wasn't it. It was, he had a representative. Listen to me, bro. He had a representative that would not listen to him, that would not answer his fucking questions as a constituent, as a person who was giving him his vote. We talking about Clyburn. Literally, he would not have been in that position were it not for people like fucking Marcel. Clyburn created Marcel. Hear me. Clyburn created fucking Marcel. And what you're doing right now, Brother Dion, is you are going to create, and I'm not going to say that I'm mad about it, but you're going to create so many more motherfucking mini Marcells, nigga. Thank you. Woo! Thank you. Because that's what we need. We need people to understand that we don't have people that are willing to put their feet in the fire, their torsos in the fire, their goddamn throats in the fire, and stand 10 toes down for us. We don't have those people that are willing to do that. So when we do find someone who is willing to do that over and over and over again, like Marcel has done, we're going to ride for them because they're speaking for us, because we don't have those people. And if you think that you're going to step into that role, number one, okay, this is who we are. We roast motherfuckers for fun. We will flame your ass, because I could get on that motherfucking indigo motherfucking suit you got on right now, but I'm a chill, okay? Because that's not what we're doing. I'm a chill. I could get on your motherfucking locks that's looking like they thirsting like the Sahara, but I'm a chill, okay? But that's what we do, okay? Because we do that to each other, because we know when we step out into the real world, that shit is so much fucking harder. It gets so much worse than that. You got so much more shit slinging at your ass from left, right, up, down. God damn it. These roasting sessions feels like motherfucking a massage session for you at that point. And if you can't put your feet, your thick ass goddamn thick ass motherfucking locks, your dry, thirsty ass lock, you can't put that shit in the fire and stand through that shit, okay, nigga, to get more people on your side to stand behind you. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say to you. I will say this. Because I'm all about evolving and growing, you know what I'm saying, and moving forward. And I think, Brother Dion, that you may have that capacity. What I want you to be open to is that whatever, and please hear me, brother, when I say this, whatever you believe in, you do not have to let go of that in order to push forward for the collective of your community. Whatever you believe in personally, you do not have to let go of that to push forward for the collective of our community. Because I don't think anybody in this space right now would argue with you that there is literally a LGBTQIA plus up, down, division, whatever, all of that, okay, against our community. Nobody's going to argue that. Nobody. We are with you, brother. Where we put a fucking hard stop is when you try to say that anybody who is gay cannot lead our community. Fuck you, respectively. Okay? Because that's not true. We know that's not fucking true. We know that your fucking sexual identity, so many other aspects of our personality are only revealed when we reveal those things. And when you, brother, as a representative of our community, hone in on those specific things, you fucking lose sight of the other things that are so much more important to our community. So many other things that are going to push our community forward, okay? Like reparations, AB 3121. Get fucking inundated with that. I want you to drench yourself in that shit, okay? I don't want to even talk to you again, my nigga, until you understand. Because I don't even live in California, okay? I'm in Washington State, all right? But I've been following AB 3121 since motherfucking September of 2021. From me listening to you, you have no idea what the fuck is going on there. And that's not even my state. But when you put reparations in your shit, and I said that earlier, you say reparations, that's putting a bat signal out, my nigga. People are going to show the fuck up, and we're going to show out. Because you're not going to say reparations and let that shit slide the fuck by and think that the fucking Black Americans are not going to be on your ass. And that's what we want. We don't want anybody out here saying reparations, and they don't mean that. We don't want anybody out here saying reparations, and they're not talking specifically about foundational Black Americans, freed men, descendants of American chattel slavery. We are so specific. Dion, I asked you earlier, who is your great-grandmama? Where they from? What's their story? What's your great-grandfather's name? What's his story? What have they been through? What have they surpassed? What have they been pushing for? That's going to give you a whole different fucking energy when you come into this conversation. And I want you, again, to humble yourself. Because, Brother Dion, this is not about you. This is not about you. I don't give a fuck about you. I don't give a fuck about Marcel. I give a fuck about what Marcel represents. I give a fuck about what you could represent. Step into your motherfucking glory, nigga. If you ain't ready for that, step all the way the fuck back and let somebody else stand into that shit. And we can keep pushing the fuck forward. If you're not ready, it's okay, brother. Don't nobody got no hate in their heart for you. Nobody. Because I actually like the color of that suit you got on. Okay, I like it. Indigo, hey, shout out to you, bro. I love it. But please understand that politics is not about the person. Politics is not about the person. It's about the collective. And if you're not ready to accept and really take on that really gigantic, that enormous responsibility, please step out of the way so somebody else who is really ready to take on this shit, like my brother Marcel, like who I will keep standing 10 toes motherfucking down, 20 toes motherfucking down until he fucks up. Because if he does, I'll be the first one, okay, in the front row to say, hold on, nigga. Just like a nana do to that little baby. And correct that shit. Okay? Until then, I'm going to be 10 toes down for my brother Marcel. And Dion, if you want to be on the same type of wavelength, I need you to do some self-reflection and understand that we ready. We ready to support. But you got to be ready to absorb and pivot and grow. So thank you. And I'm done.
And that brings us to an end. I think that is a very good way to end this and close out this space. All right. We ended it with clarity. We ended with a new peace of mind. I think everybody said what they needed to say. And I'm going to give my final statement. Today, we did a recap of Marcel and Dion as they stand politically. And we learned that Marcel, we already know that he's the people champ. He's been vetted so many times, and he's proved himself time and time again to the grassroots, and he's going to continue to do so. Brother Dion, you have a lot to learn in this political space, and with our reparations claim and our reparations advocacy, and that's very clear to see. And the reason why my sister Cherie said what she said is because you had a chance to end this on a positive note, but you brought up against a stance that you saying that you won't change. And again, you messed up again, because like I said, the last thing that I got from you is that you're talking about LGBTQ, this or that or the third. And now my last impression of you is going to be the same exact thing. And that's a shame. What should be at the forefront of everything is your reparations advocacy. And you failed yet again. Now, when you get off of here, don't strike out again. Because the grassroots, we never stay and strike out. Because we're on code. And I'm going to end this with my sister Cherie's favorite song by Shoe Gang, My Reparations.
Do all we can. Seek to lift ourselves by our bootstraps. It's a cruel jest to say to a bootless man that he ought to lift himself by his own bootstraps.
Now we ain't asking for a handout, forget the worst treatment. Hands down, my kind of shot with their hands up, so just hand us some land now. Yeah, 40 acres in a mule, big. picture, I'm loading bangers with a full clip. Give 40 million blacks a full scholarship to any school, bitch. You know they say we got a reputation of spending money.
He didn't stay and support the artist.
On jewel shit, but even Massa Musa had jewels, bitch. That's king shit. Boss shit. Let's buy the block and we all rich. Nip toe, draw this word to Crenshaw. Slossy, let's link up together. Put a little bit of green box together. We should have received fuck each other. Back during the reconstruction era, 1863 gave us free papers. Should have got free paper shit. Like $6 million, man, like Lee Majors. We gave up 244 years of free labor. They repaid us with a